Hello.
What's up?
You went to an HBCU, right?
I say it every show.
That's right. Howard University graduate.
Listen, man, that school has shaped me to the man that I am today. I'm proud.
You should be.
Yes.
You know what I'm proud of?
What are you proud
of?
It's
June, and we're going to join Cricket Wireless in celebrating HBCU music programs during Black Music Month.
Because
that's what June is, right? Okay. Because HBCU marching bands are showstoppers from the word go. They are a force of nature and a force for good. Mm-hmm. They raise the bar and expectations every single time they set foot onto the field. I've been to sort of HBCU like homecomings and parties, whatever. People don't even get lit for the football game.
Listen,
the
Clark Atlanta, Howard, Hampton, A&T, FAMU, Tuskegee. Bro, like those marching bands are just immaculate, the spirit. And they was in Homecoming with Beyonce.
Absolutely.
Wow.
So they are the epitome of poetry in motion. And just like Black music, they are unstoppable.
Mm-hmm.
Shout out Cricket Wireless.
Mm-hmm.
Let's start the show. Pop people, welcome back to Say Less. Kaz, Lowkey, Rosie, Jake's here. Love to our boy Eden. He's not here today, but we wish him the best. Hope he's doing all right.
We love you.
We love you so much, brother. But we got Jordana here filling in.
What's good? What's good?
How you doing?
Yo, what's that Netflix series?
Which one?
The Black people, white people.
Black people, white people.
No,
white
but
people?
You know what you're
really
talking about.
Yeah, I
guess. There's a lot of black people and white people.
White people?
Black.
Dear white people.
Okay,
white. That's what she reminded me of because you know she had a radio show.
Yeah, yeah.
She said, what's good? What's good?
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
I can see
that's
that.
What she reminded me of.
Black people, white people.
Black people, white people.
Like, yeah, there's a lot of black people and white people shows.
My brothers and sisters.
Very Nubian. I respect it. I respect it. We got Jordan pitching in for Eden today. Lo, do your thing.
Oh, yeah, this is Lowkey from Howard University.
I tried again. Run it back.
Bro, I'm hungover.
I know we are. It's a little earlier than we
Yeah, and it's early.
It's too early.
Yeah. It's a little early.
I almost didn't wake up.
This is Lowkey from Howard University, host of Hip Hop R&B Throwback on Apple Music, hits every day, 9 to 10 p.m. Eastern Time. Check out the past episodes if you want. And Rap Life Review with Ebro and Adeska every Wednesday on Apple Music. And I'm sitting right here with my family.
Yeah.
With Say Less.
Yeah.
With Kaz.
Yeah.
Rosie.
Uh-huh.
Talk to
Jake.
Him.
That's right.
Eden.
Word.
What's up?
Yeah.
And Jordana.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, and the little Dominican cousin in the corner.
Boss, nigga. You y'all, see me.
Y'all ain't see me. Shout out to the Dominican cousin in the corner.
Shout out Pablo.
Pablo.
My little brother's
what's up,
here.
Pablo? Gang, gang. With
my little brother's
family.
Here.
Come on, get your camera shot. We have my cousin on.
He'll do it quick. Look. Hey, look.
Y'all
the fuck out of here.
Y'all show y'all related.
Yeah, right? Exactly.
Can't see the resemblance.
I would have never done that.
Never would have.
Never.
The apple does not fall
from
too far from the tree.
Actually, we're probably the only ones that are like this, though. Like, the rest of our family is different.
Very meek, very chill.
They're chill. Like, y'all, we're like the
extroverts. Yes, I could tell.
The extra ones. You could have stopped that extra.
Listen, I'm trying to give y'all, you know, the actual proper Webster's Dictionary definition.
Maybe my middle brother is like that, too. That's it.
Well, shout out to family. It's always good to have family in the building, especially last week. My brother, my cousin,
sheesh,
Habib, came through with the Abishola.
Abishola.
I was in bed by 8 p.m.
on a Saturday with that Abishola.
Anytime I say or hear that name now, I'm just like,
ooh.
Shudder.
Yo, we were in the group chat like, guys, I'm smacked.
So listen, I don't know if we're ever going to do this, right? And we rarely ever talk about, you know, the process of making the show.
Mm-hmm.
But last week was the first episode that we had to have. The people who really, like, study this show will catch the edits. This is the first episode that we really had to be like, this can't stay. This can't stay.
We had so many edits.
Oh my God.
There was a lot of edits.
I almost fought Lo.
Yes, Lo and Rosie almost got it to
him. I mean, like, I didn't give a fuck. Like, I didn't care. That's why I said it. I didn't give a fuck.
Oh my God.
Yeah, I didn't give a fuck.
First of all, we left here. Guys, when we left the show last week, we left here. We went to the train station for 10 minutes.
Hold on.
We left here. We were supposed to go somewhere. We went to a train station.
No, we didn't have a destination in mind.
We sat in the train station for 10 minutes, came back up, and everybody went home.
Everyone wanted diet. So we wanted to either eat or go somewhere.
But the fact that we just stood there.
We stood outside for like 10 minutes.
Any group of friends, right? Like, there's levels of smack that you get to. Yeah. Right, like the level of smack where you're still kind of conscious.
Yeah, but we still want to go, keep going.
Like, yeah, like that's a good level of smack. That is the level of smack
that you want to be.
That you want to be when we're your friends.
That's the goal.
See, you were a different level of smack. Because the level of smack.
You were No.
On life,
I was good.
I was in between Lo and Kaz.
No,
this is the level of smack that was.
He was smack because he had edible.
No, he was smack 10. You were smack like 6. Mm. I was in between y'all.
No, this is how I knew he was smacked. Because he couldn't open his eyes? No, he kept asking me after the episode was over. He was like, yo, we should re-record.
He's like, we should listen to it, right?
I'm like, yo, shut up.
We should listen to it first, right?
I was so, for some reason,
you had mad anxiety.
I never do this.
You were on edibles. You
know, that's what I'm saying. That's why he was fucking higher than we were. Yeah, because of this idiot over here.
Let's be clear, okay?
Who?
First edibles. You give us COVID, yeah, then you give us edibles.
He give you
Let's be clear, okay?
That mean one.
Edibles, under most circumstances,
Are fun.
You can handle
yourself. Then you give like 100 grand.
Usually like 20, let me tell the fucking story. Like, usually like a good 20 milligram, 30 milligram will get you like a nice, good buzz. You know what I mean? Throughout the day, it'll be all right.
Mm-hmm.
Jake, however,
are we gonna put me out there?
Don't ever take edibles from white people, though.
Listen, so
bro.
That's rule number one.
The chocolate
might have been some other shit.
I don't know what it was, but the wrapper on it looked like, I don't know. Remember Kablam?
He gave you shrooms, bro.
Remember Kablam on Nickelodeon back in the day? Like the wrapper looked like that. It was too much. It was too animated for me to trust.
Gave you meth
under my own.
Gave him meth. Try this new strand, Kaz.
Kaz was leaning, but never fell.
Hey,
Kaz was like,
fell. Hey, Kaz ass.
That's what I'm saying. Listen, I held
Kaz
it down.
Kaz is in a subway, paranoid, like, where are we going?
He's like, guys, we should go back upstairs. The train?
It was a bad combination.
It's coming, guys.
It was a bad combination. First off, it was Jake's like ultra strength edible on top of the Abishola. On top of
the Abishola.
It was my first time in a subway. In like
second
13 months second
we took it the other day when we went to remember
when
we went to Sahara the first time that you stayed out that night.
I did,
yeah.
Okay,
you're like, I haven't been here in a long time.
Oh yeah, you did take
that. Oh shit, okay.
Yeah, cause you left your car.
So it was my right yeah, okay car, yeah. So it was my second time taking a subway in like 14 months on top of that, and it was hot, yeah. And there was no trains coming. We were all smacked,
but you?
Nobody had plans, so we were just standing there in the subway looking like idiots for like 20 minutes, just like.
I knew, I said, let's go to Sahara. And everybody was like, all right, let's go to Sahara. Mm. So we sat in the fucking train station. And meanwhile, there's a sign that says no trains are coming for 28 minutes. We sat there for a legit 15 minutes until we just looked to our right, and that shit was there.
We would have stood there for another 20 minutes if my anxiety wasn't kicking in. I was like, bro, we've been here for quite a while, guys.
And I'm just like, yo, Cash, shut the fuck up.
I don't mind taking an Uber, guys.
He's like, let's go back upstairs. I'm like, fine. So we went back upstairs. We got... And then we just sat there, and then
everyone just split.
Everybody just dispersed.
We did all that for nothing, is what we're saying.
I got in a cab. That nigga went somewhere.
I went home.
She went home, and like
I was in bed. I didn't even make it to my bed. I fell asleep on my couch at 7:30 p.m.
I was cooked.
I thought you didn't go to.
No, I went home, bro. I couldn't go anywhere. I was smacked.
I thought you went somewhere else.
I couldn't. I was. Nah, I'm gonna be. I'm,
you got this bad news bears for me last week, but this week,
yeah, that was true.
We back.
We are back. We are coherent.
Are we?
For now,
I'm coherent. Well,
it's way better than it was last
way
week.
It's a little
last.
Early.
Way better. Yeah, it's too early.
I feel like the mixture of last night and the earliness right now is like. Ugh.
If we got here like at 3, I think
we'd be better.
Okay.
Yeah.
Be okay.
I mean, it's not like
we're taping early.
We're not bugging, but it's just.
I appreciate y'all making the time for me. I had to.
We're just tired. Like we're all just tired.
We're hungover. Is what they're trying to say.
Film festival this weekend, so I had to go and check out. The I Promise documentary with LeBron that's dropping at the festival, so that's why we got to go. Well, that's why I got to go in a few hours. And I was with y'all last night. Well, with you last night.
Yeah.
A little smack.
Yeah, yeah. We were at the spot watching the, you know, the
Y'all were supposed to come like me.
We was on our way to get you.
So it was all right, so
so we were
here we go.
So let me tell you my how I linked to you, right?
Yeah,
so
yeah.
I'm at another dinner for Spring Hill and gang, and
yeah,
it was a great dinner too. Like good room. Haven't been in a good ass room like that for a while. Like Robin Roberts was there, fucking Desus was there, bunch of people from the shop, and you know, PR and all of those guys. Good ass room, like,
right?
You know, so eating, drinking. Shout out Ronde was there. Good time, really good time. I was like, man, hit Low up. Low, where you at? Need some fellowship. Pulling up, Low Key's Corner. I still haven't seen Low Key's Corner.
Yeah, in person.
Person, yes. Me so either. I was like, if I'm not going back to Jersey until I go and pay respects to the legendary Low Key's Corner on Sahara East in New York. Before I even continue the story, you have like an actual like monument in the city now, right? Like, you know this. Like, people who like this show that are from New York,
literally just like walk Kruger, past there, he's gonna be there.
He will be there
no matter the time.
And you can't sit there unless Lowe gives you the go ahead that you're allowed to sit
there. It's like, I mean, if you listen to the show, if you're like, you consistently listen to the show, you know that that's where I frequent after this, after we tape, or after, like, you know, every day after I record, you know, my Apple show. So it's like, it's a hookah spot, and I've been going there for like last like 6-7 years. And last weekend after we left, this is when we were all smacked.
Yeah, Smack City, yes.
Yeah.
So after
smack
we left.
City, bitch, Smack City, bitch.
After we left, I went over there, they went home, and my boy Ahmed, who
correct,
the manager of
shout
the spot.
Out,
shout out to Ahmed and Mufasa. I walk in and they just light it up. And I'm like, yo, what the fuck? Like, what is this? And they're like, well, yo, your family. Like, that's the only response they gave me. They was like, yo, your family.
Aww.
So they were like, yo, no one can sit there if you're not here. We're not going to light it up if you're not here.
Fuck be that. Honest. Be honest. Be honest.
I teared up.
You choked up.
Look. I choked I up. You. No, I did. I did. I did. And you got to think, I was on the Abbey Solo.
I choked up for you, too. Yeah. I was just like, that is up. Really fucking cool.
I was on the Abbey Solo.
Yeah,
he was on the Abbey Solo. I was off the Abbey Solo, too. So over like the last like week and a half, like a bunch of my friends been coming over there and just like, you know, Instagramming and this, that, and the third. Like, if you look at my stories, you see people just like posting the pictures. You was there last night. Yeah. You haven't seen
I haven't been. I haven't been in person. Maybe I'll go after this.
Yeah, but it's
I'm
like
not Smack City.
I'm never Smack. But it's like, it's been a lot of people come over there and just being like, yo, that's crazy that you have your own corner. And it's just like, I don't, that's just where I feel comfortable sitting.
Listen, man,
it was fun.
In my eyes, you keep the lights on over there. So anybody who's ever in New York City, you like hookah, you like good food, good drinks, good place to watch the game, good place to kick it, go to Low Key's Corner at Sahara East.
Yo, Low, you better, you know you're lucky you don't got no beef. Like, you're not hard to find.
You're not?
No, but like, y'all know me. Like,
you're
y'all
not
know.
Hard to find, bro.
No, I'm not. I always tell people, I'm like, yo, if I ever have an issue, like, y'all know where to find me.
Mm-hmm.
You're not.
But I'm
hard
not
to
that,
find.
But I'm also not that person.
I know you with the shit.
I need a
too.
Pillow, because someone, can someone give me a pillow?
You got a pillow right here? Anyway.
But yeah, so, all right, so aside from that,
thank you.
Continue telling your story.
So, night's going good. I'm like, all right, I'm about to go pull up on Low. You know what I mean? Go, you know, keep the night going. Game's still going on. Mm-hmm. The whole other half left. I'm at least going to watch the end of the game, kick it out Low Key's Corner, see it with my own two eyes, and then we'll just see where the night takes us from there. Right.
Mm-hmm.
Game ends. Shout out to LA Clippers. Incredible game. Incredible comeback.
Yeah.
Shout out PG. Took a lot of shit. Took a lot.
Last two games.
No
last
Kawhi.
Two games.
He's
been
no
put, him and not, Reggie Jackson.
Not a lot of players could
Terrence.
Come back from.
And Terrence, yeah, Terrence.
Not a lot of players could come back from the sort of slander PG was getting from all walks of life.
Right.
And he came back from it pretty well. So salute to that man. Go to the Western Conference Finals. Salute to Terrence, man. Brooklyn native. You know what I mean? They balled out.
Mm-hmm.
So game was over. It was rocking. Then
you get a text message.
So, all right, so we got
to put Alita.
We got to put context. So
I hit him with the year.
I was with our boy Mello. You know,
shout out Shamel.
Childhood friend of Kaz.
Family friend.
Family friend. Yeah. So I'm just like, yo, I don't know if we should go to Biggie's. It's like, it's hectic over there. Like, we good right here. We're comfortable. Music is blasting. Girls is in. Like, da 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 da. We getting drinks. I don't know if we should go over there. Kaz is like, yo, en route. So I'm like, all right.
Package all right. Yeah. On the way.
So I'm like, all right.
Tracking package.
I know where this could go. So Mello gets like 2 texts. Yo, we have Biggie's. Pull up.
Yeah.
I'm like,
no. I think we all got like,
bro, like it was all text. Like, yo.
Like within like the 3 minutes, it's like, yo, come to Biggie's, come to Biggie's.
So I got like three, I got, bro. I got like 3 or 4 texts. Like, yeah. Yo, come, like Shorty was supposed to meet me at Sahara. I was like, yo, I'm at Biggie's, come to Biggie's.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm like, all right. Then this motherfucker FaceTimes me, then calls you. And yeah. Was like, yo, we at Biggie.
Well, one of y'all was going to pick up. Yeah. Don't ignore my call, goddammit.
Like,
yeah.
No, because like you called me, but it only rung once. And then you called him.
Okay.
And then he was like, yo, Rosie's at Biggie's. I'm like, then Roxy and me. She's,
oh, I did see Roxy there.
Yeah, Roxy and her homegirl Mary was there.
Okay.
So they hit me. They was like, yo, come to Biggie's.
Okay.
So I'm like, yo, Cass.
Let's roll.
Where's the car at? He's like, round the corner.
Round the corner.
Like, let's go get it. So I told I met in Mufasa. I'm like, yo, I'll be back in like 30 minutes. I just got to go show face at this spot. I'm going to bring motherfuckers back over here.
Mm.
He was like, all right, we're going to be open until 2. It's a night.
It's going to be a night.
Get in the car.
Roll.
We rolling.
We rolling.
Music's blasting. I'm in the phone. I'm telling people like, yo, we on the way.
On the
we
way.
Gonna, yo, we in a good route. Mood. Yo, y'all just got a haircut. We out. Like, we going to do this tonight. Boom.
The fuck was that?
What happened?
I look over to the right.
I look over to the
my
right.
My whole passenger side rearview mirror.
I hate when you do this with
it's
your
it's just
head.
Like a limp penis, bro. Like it just, it was erect and then it was just dangling like this. I'm like, what the?
Mr. Softy.
I'm like, it was Mr. Softy out of nowhere. I'm like, what happened?
Bro, really had no idea.
And I'm looking around, I'm like, I'm like, well, did somebody hit me? I'm like, did somebody like just hit, like take a bat to my
and
shit?
The thing is, he wasn't driving crazy, and we weren't zooming through, like we were actually like just like it was like a
it was a red light coming up.
Yeah, so we were like just like coasting through the
somebody
you know,
opened
the
door. What happened?
So it was an Uber driver, and I guess like the passenger or whoever
he got out on the street side.
He got off on the street side instead of the passenger side, which is you know a little bit of the Uber driver's fault. Like, hey, when you drop somebody off, make sure you drop them off by the fucking sidewalk.
Yeah, motherfuckers is fucked up. Outside is different.
I get it. It's outside.
It's the Walking Dead out here.
All that type of stuff. As I'm driving, as soon as he opens the door, it just smacks the window off, scratches the whole side of my Benz, and I'm just sitting there, just like all that high energy I had to go kick it, all that time I was
depleted, ready
to go kick it.
Yo, this man was deflated.
All joined under. Bro, I'm seeing everybody there. I'm like, all right.
Bro, he was seeing red when he got out the car. And like it took everything in me. I'm like, yo, I'm like, Kaz, don't do it.
I was not gonna react.
I'm
like,
Kaz, don't. No, bro, like you was moving in circles. I'm like, please just stay here. So me and Mello went over to talk to the driver and the dude that, you know, did the door shit. He was just like, yo, my fault. Like I ain't mean it. Like it was just like an accident. Like he was like mad apologetic.
He was mad apologetic.
Yeah, so
which was the
funny thing is, dude was like, y'all good? Bet. I'm out.
I'm like,
word? I'm like,
well, what else was he supposed to do?
That is like, what else could he have done?
Thankfully, though, it was an Uber, so it's like.
Yeah, like, what else is he like? He has no position. He has no dog in this fight.
Even though it is his fault. You know what I mean? He did open the door. He didn't go out in the side.
But no, he apologized. Whatever. But yeah, that. I was tight because I'm like, damn, like we was all in a great
night ruined.
And I kept telling Mello and him, I'm like, yo, there was something over there that we didn't need to be. Yeah, we was not supposed to be over there.
No, it was great.
Yep.
I'm sure for y'all.
There was nothing wrong. One of us three was
not supposed to be over there.
Something was keeping me from being there. That
it was awesome. Yeah.
No,
it was
I'm sure it was fucking fun.
Lots to do.
It looked great.
It was like, yo, listen,
it looked fucking great. But there was a reason why we weren't supposed to be over there.
If that's how you trying to make make yourself feel better.
We could have easily went.
he got fucked.
Yo, bro, don't even worry about it. Don't even worry about it.
Cause she's gonna off you.
No, I was tight. We couldn't go.
For like a good hour and a half, I was hot.
I know you were.
For a good hour and a half, I was hot.
Yo,
I've never been in a car accident in my life. I don't even know what to do.
That's why I just told you. I was like, put your car over there.
All the other stuff, like I've never
take a picture. Take a picture of his car. Take a picture of your shit. Take a picture of his license, insurance, exchange all that shit. Boom, and that's it. And he was like, "Yo, let me call the cops." I'm like, "Yo, bro, like they're gonna do the same thing we just did.
Yeah,
there's nothing they can do.
Yeah,
like everything we did, they're gonna do that.
Yeah, they didn't run away, which is cool.
No, he just said, like, did you get all his information? Yeah. He was like, yeah. I was like, there's nothing we can do.
It is what it is, bro. Yeah, so. Shout out to my deductible. It'll be all right, bro.
But I don't give a fuck. There was something over there that we should not have been involved
in. I believe in the spirits.
I believe
in the spirits. Like,
I mean, it was a long wait at the bar, that's about it.
We was already smamming. I'm probably sure she did some dumb shit last night.
Sure
she
did.
I didn't. Mm. I didn't. I went to go eat. That's where you with Roy.
Yeah,
but they were taking too long there too. So I just ended up going to my block and getting fried shrimp and fries from across the street and going home.
Fried shrimp. Mm. Oh, from the Chinese spot?
No, from a seafood spot that's across the street, 24 hours.
A seafood spot? Open
it. Yeah, it's a fish spot. Oh, yeah. It's fire.
Oh yeah, you gotta be uptown to get that fried meat and fish at any time of the night.
Well, no, it's a Jamaican spot on 135th and like 8th that's open 24
it's
hours.
It's like the fish spot on 25th.
Okay.
That's spot's fire too.
That's another New York staple mm-hmm. right there. That fried fish.
But now, yeah, we stayed in the spot last night till about 4:30. Yeah, 4:30. Yeah. Took it home.
Good times.
That was it.
Good times though.
But anywho, it was old school New York and Biggie's. Like I walked in and it was just I would turn around everybody at. Every time I turned around, I saw somebody else I know. I was like, I don't want to be here. It was Mixville.
Mama's back outside,
see,
like, man.
It was Mixville.
That's what I'm saying.
It was like Project X last lap.
That's what I'm saying. It's an unintended consequence of being back outside, right? Because I forget how many people I don't want to see outside. Like, there's always a
that
good
you don't want
a
small talk. You're like,
oh, hey. Someone was good. Hey, bro.
The IG
picture that was going viral this past 2 weeks, like what? 8 phrases that sound like support.
Oh, yeah. I saw that.
It's like 8 phrases that sound like support, but is secretly really hating.
What were they?
One is like, what's up, Hollywood? Or two was like, right. Yo, I'm trying to get like you. Or three. Like all these phrases. I'm sure
you'll find it. I didn't see that.
Positive vibes only.
Positive vibes. Nah, I don't think that was on there, but let me see if I can find it real
quick. What's up, Hollywood? Shut the fuck up.
I cannot with that shit. All right, boom. Like here it is.
I'm like that right now. Okay, what are they?
8 so-called phrases that have an undertone of hating. Yeah. I'll say them, Jordan, Pablo, everybody. Let me know if you've ever heard this before. I'll start from 8 to 1. Mm-hmm. 8. Don't forget about me when you blow up. Come on.
My parents would say that shit. my parents would say that just like to be fucking with me.
But that's a phrase that like could seem like, you know, like I'm trying to, you know, I see you're on your way up there and like don't forget about the little people. I pretty much say like, yo, I know you finna change because you about to get all this money.
My response is like, nigga, shut the fuck up. And
I said like, next. I will. Yeah, like, next.
Number 7.
Who are you again?
It's not really hard to do. That's hating.
It's not really hard
it's
to
not really
do.
Hard no, to do.
Where would it? How would they even have a what's opening to say that?
I don't know. For example, if somebody was like, "Yo, here, Say Less podcast is popping off," like, you know, it's like you just get into a
I've never heard any. No, I've
it's
never
not that hard to do.
I've never gotten that.
No,
I've never gotten that.
No, I've never got. It's not
okay. Instagram.
Yeah, I never.
Round one goes to you. Number 6, and here's one. How's your quote unquote little business doing?
Yo! This is funny because me and my homegirl Tina
from Chicago, we was out to dinner like 2 weeks ago.
Oh, I like
her. Yeah, like, yeah, you know, see. So she was like, I seen your little clip on Instagram. Yeah. I seen your little show. And I'm like, little show.
She was like, yo, I didn't mean it like that.
Like, that's just her lingo. But like,
I'm sure you don't mean it like
that. She didn't mean it, but I was telling her, I'm like, yo, bro, like, that's kind of a sign of disrespect. So now I always fuck with her about it. I'm like, yeah, my little show about to. So I get that. But like, I know she wasn't hating. So just, if she sees this, I know you're not hating. But just.
Do you have a little business story? Anybody?
No, yeah. There was someone last night. They didn't say little, but it was straight hate, and I'll tell y'all who it is afterwards. Okay. And he was like, we were at the bar at Last Lab, we're about to do a shot, and he was like, I was like, yo, I can't be out too late because for some reason we got to do something early. But I didn't say it in front of him. He's like, yeah, she got to wake up early and do her little podcast. And I was like, I actually do, bitch. I was like, actually, I really do.
Well, that's what a we at right now. So listen,
I was like, I actually do. I gotta wake up.
I understand
earlier than usual.
Yes, I understand what people are saying. Like, they're probably just saying that because they want you to stay out and have fun, and you know, whatever you could take
care. They're also saying, I see you, but I'm not gonna like.
But really, why is that to be little? Because yo, I see you in your little show. No, I saw your little like clip.
Because it's like a, I seen it. Those are the same people that watch your shit and don't like it.
Yeah. Yes.
Those are the same people. They see what you're doing, but they don't acknowledge it.
They check your page and they don't follow.
Yeah. Like, they'll watch your stories, but they won't like your pictures. Instagram those are those people.
Numbers and the view count numbers don't add up to the
like. Yo, my views on my stories are crazy, but then my likes are like nothing. And I'm like, yo, y'all are trash.
I respect it.
Nah, my likes is.
But you're a likable guy, Lo.
My likes are on point.
You're a likable guy.
My likes and my views are on point. I don't know what y'all little likes are about, but
I get my little likes.
Shut up.
I get my little likes.
I don't know what y'all little views is about.
Don't make me take my little. Listen. Don't make me put little clothes on.
You got the highest engagement rate?
Don't make me put little clothes on.
I ain't about to do it. Females just wear less clothes. We know you get the engagement. Yo, I could have been doing that same thing, but I got responsibilities.
What?
Who the fuck says that?
That's straight hate.
That is.
You can't even say that with a straight face.
That's not even so-called positive. That is straight up.
There's nothing positive about
Let's skip that one.
Yeah, like, skip that one. Next. I've never heard that
number
shit
before.
No, you heard this before.
That's it?
You lucky.
That's it?
That's it.
You lucky.
You lucky. Yeah, I'm the good. Yo, I'm telling you, yo, man, we got things happen. This. Oh, man, yo, you so lucky, yo.
Yeah.
You never get that?
I've gotten that
plenty of times.
Because it discredits the work.
I see.
Discredits the work.
Yeah.
You lucky. It makes you feel like you just got put in a position.
You're just the right person at the right time. Mm-hmm.
But look, it's like
anybody could do it. You know what I'm saying?
I'm looking at it from a standpoint of like someone got a kid or someone's like married. Like, damn, yo, you lucky you can be out here.
But with context, yes. But no.
Yeah, I've heard it in context, but I've never heard like I don't know who the fuck y'all niggas be around, but like ain't no one ever told me you lucky. Like, no, bitch. That's like I struggled and I fucking earned and I fucking studied and
Tall
I fucking like love what I do. Ain't no luck around here, my nigga. I'm lucky I got up this morning after all the shit I was doing last night, but the success, that ain't luck, bitch.
That's where the luck comes
from. Man,
that's the luck right there. I'm lucky to be here right now.
Yeah, I should still be asleep right now.
Let's get to the top three. Top three is some heavy hitters right here.
For real?
Number three, must be nice.
I've gotten that in so many situations. How do you even respond to that?
That's such a blatant hater.
It's pretty nice.
That's how I respond.
That's blatant hate.
As soon as I hear must be nice, I think of the hater from Paid in Full.
Okay.
Talk about money making Mitch. We know you got all the money, Mitch. It's like I broke, baby.
Yes.
Like that's what you sound like when you say it must be nice.
If anyone says must be nice to you, you respond subtly. Yes.
Yes, it is
pretty fucking nice.
And keep that shit moving. Whether it's a VIP line, mm-hmm. whether it's a steak dinner, whatever it is.
Must be nice. Correct. It is.
Correct. It is very nice.
Very nice, actually.
I earned this. This is what I work for. I work for nice things.
Maybe one day.
Right. But probably not. My face, man.
But not anytime soon. Yeah. Number two.
We're talking like we like millionaires on this show.
What's up, big time?
What's up, Hollywood?
Nothing.
Nothing.
Nah. What's up?
Never been there.
You see?
Sorry.
My name is Kazim. You can say, what's up, Kazim? It's not big time.
What's up,
Hollywood?
Hollywood.
I live in New York.
I've gotten to Hollywood too, but it's like. Let's talk about being called Hollywood, yo. How do you feel
when somebody calls you Hollywood? Stupid.
I mean, like, it's from what, and this is just me speaking, what I do and the places that we've been and the things that we're associated with, I understand the context of the phrase.
Mm-hmm.
But I'm still the stubborn, ignorant, drunken fool that smokes hookah that's still like outside whatever, like, so I get it. Like, you know, I was hosting shows and parties, I have my show on Apple Music, this, that, and the third. I get it.
Yeah,
the standard of what I do can say, it could say Hollywood.
Yes,
but it's just like, I still wear
it goes right back to what I was saying. To me, the What's Up Hollywood is like, is the same person that sees your page and just keeps scrolling. Like the people that watch you but don't acknowledge you type shit.
No, I've gotten to Hollywood.
Like, damn, I never got a text from you saying congrats. Nothing.
I've gotten to Hollywood from the people that watched my stories, liked my posts. Like, I've gotten to Hollywood from those people as well.
But I see that as like, I see you killing it.
That's not, sometimes, all you had to do is say like, yo bro, I see you out here, yo, you doing your thing. Like that Hollywood shit, that's a double.
Secure enough in
but themselves, that's what I'm saying. Like, I do understand sometimes they'll say some shit. Like, you know, we're ball busters sometimes. Yeah. So yeah. Like, to some people, that's a form of ball busting. It was like, oh, what's up, Big Time? What's up, Hollywood? Yeah. But there's other folks, that have earned that sort of comfortability with you.
So we're not talking to those folks.
Not talking to those folks. Yeah. No. There's other people out there that will really say that shit to you and really be hating the biggest.
Yeah. I mean, it is what it is.
We had an interesting commenter this weekend, right?
What comment?
I don't read the comments, so.
Rosie and Lowe.
Oh, Rosie and Lowe, the new big podcast it couple.
The conspiracy theory.
Picture that. That's the last thing I need.
Lozy.
Motherfuckers thinking,
touching each other.
They made me go to the timestamp. I was like, touching. Something like this. And I was like, what?
Oh.
Where are you from that means we're dating
now? Check him out.
First of all, if anyone who listens to this that wants to date me is sick, that's number one. Facts. Do you hear the shit I say?
I was about to say, like, this is like, you know, when people have post something like, yo, if you want to date me seriously, like, don't follow me on Twitter.
Yeah.
This is like that time.
This is 100. That. No, it's like, if you listen to this and still want me, something's wrong with you.
Mm-mm.
Well, no, that's not fair.
Well, do you hear the shit I say?
Well, don't doubt yourself like that.
So we're dating.
I wouldn't date you. No.
Look.
I wouldn't. Because I'm not.
Y'all can see this off camera, but when we first met, Romy hit him with a
hell no. He was so offended.
No, I'm just saying, everything that I know about her, no, I would not.
I was like, hell no.
Date your ass either.
Hell, then he got so offended. He's like, I wouldn't want you either.
Bro, like, what the fuck?
He
like,
said, you're not even my top five, dead
or alive. You're definitely not. Like, I'm cool,
you ain't even make top 10, bitch.
Cool. Let's be honest. This is a safe space, okay?
It's not safe at all.
Whatever you're about to say, like, no, nigga, fuck her. Like, whatever you're about to ask.
Friends here, they're clearly not dating.
We're not dating.
The last thing I need any motherfucker out there to think that I'm dating this.
Well, first of all, fuck you.
Now you know how I felt, you dickhead.
That's what I'm saying, though. Even though we're friends, you still don't want to be like.
First of all,
I didn't need that. Like Niall, like him. Like, hey, bro, really? What's wrong with me? Like, I'm respectful to you. I treat you nice. I stick up for you. Like,
I just feel like I can do better. I'm sorry.
Like, I know it's not there, but
it's very Seinfeld in a way.
I'm just like
commenters. Like, you think
they would have something, and then once somebody brings it up, it's like, oh, what are you talking about? What are you talking about?
I just don't.
No, but they actually fucked.
I just don't need. I just.
Right, they did. Right.
I just don't need. I don't need the aggressiveness to come out when like.
Nobody likes to be told.
Yo, that would be a crazy.
Bro, like, no matter who it is. Yo, hold on.
It doesn't matter who it is.
So, are you offended by that?
You should be a little offended.
I was. If you still,
don't touch me. They think we're dating.
Yo, if you would have said like, Lowe's my bro. Like, you know, he cool and shit like that.
I get it, you're a good dude, great guy, great person.
It was my reaction.
The nigga gonna talk about fuck no. Alright, that's what's up. That's what's up, my nigga. Right, like,
how low do you think I'd go? Come on.
Alright, that's what's up.
Shout out to whoever put that on the YouTube comments.
No, man, fuck it. Talk about
I was about to say some shit, but I'm like, we're not gonna do no edits.
We're not gonna do no edits. Go ahead.
No, I'm not.
Without mentioning names, what were you about to say?
Nah, I'm cool, bro.
I like ugly motherfuckers. Go ahead. I'm about to Eminem myself.
I'm just Eminem myself,
so you can't say nothing.
It's not a big secret you're a fan of the medium uglies.
I like medium ugly. I like a schmedium ugly.
You've said this many times.
I do say that.
There you go.
Wait,
Speaking of,
is it because they give good dick?
So last episode, hold on. So last episode, when I said I like dark skinned men.
Mm. Oh God, no!
Don't bring this up, please. Please, 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 don't bring this up. The
Remember the dick pic I sent you?
I didn't see Amazon. You wasn't on the group chat?
No, you saw that. You saw that.
No, I didn't.
Yo, there's a listener.
For the sake of, I hate you so much.
For the sake of FCC regulations, we're not going to put the photo that was sent to Rosie.
I didn't see that.
Following this episode.
Yo, Cass almost choked. He said, oh, God, no.
Bro, I didn't see that.
It was, and I wish Edwin was here, too.
No, I'm good. I'm good.
No, you're good.
I wish Edwin was here to talk about it, too.
Oh, my God.
He was like, yo, not for nothing, yo.
Edwin said, low-key, that shit winked at me. Yo, Edit is different, bro.
Please, shout out
to you, my guy.
Yo, stay out of my Snapchat. I've gotten 4 dick like snappers.
Oh, Jesus!
I didn't send you the white boy.
I don't need to see any of them.
Okay, I'm sorry.
I'm good,
bro. We're not your homegirls.
No,
we're not your homegirls.
They're listeners, so I feel like y'all gotta be stuck with me.
This is when I know we're getting too close. Okay.
Yeah, like you should. Yeah, don't. That's
you,
yeah. We're
yeah,
way too girl, close. Lydia. Yeah.
Way too close.
No, I sent this to y'all because in Spanish, like, she was like, "I heard on the podcast that you like dark skinned men."
Bro, send that shit to.
He was like, "I'm Jamaican and some shit," and I was like, "Okay." Then he sends me that shit.
You have this. No,
don't send it.
Guys that are fans of the show that support. You know, in a
y'all can send
way.
Her dick pics, like that's fine.
No, it's not fine.
You should not do that.
Do not send. We had a whole segment about unsolicited dick pics. Did you miss that episode?
We had a whole episode.
No, send them hard.
No,
what?
Stop. All right, stop.
Okay,
I'm gonna send them to you, Jake. From now on,
no more vodka for you, bro.
What?
No more absolute.
The more I've done this show, and the more I've been around you guys. The more I realize that, like, not just in general, but I've known this for a while, that women have it really, really tough. Like, really tough.
Well, that's obvious. That's obvious.
Like,
that's very obvious.
This is what you do, though, guys. Jordan, I'm sure you have group chats of female friends. Rosie, I know you have group chats of female friends.
I have a few of them.
There's only one or two things that happen when you send the schlong pic unsolicited to somebody, right?
Right.
One, and the percentage of this is very low, especially when, I don't know, I'm sure y'all could speak to this, but especially if it's unsolicited, don't know this person. I have never seen that happen, but like somebody just throwing a dick pic out and then being like, dope. Great, I will meet you at this time.
Never
happens. Whatever you think is gonna happen, that never really.
Well, actually.
What actually does happen is what happened this week.
You get so many dick pics.
You get served into the group chat of group chats.
Of group chats.
Girls group chats.
I said this is like 4 different group chats.
And they just roast you for hours.
Nobody roasted that, man. They were like, what the fuck is that? And why? Like,
if they don't understand this rule by now, if they don't understand this concept by now, they'll never get it. If you're still sending unsolicited dick pics and you don't know that picture is going to be circulating in different various group chats,
it's just moving like a Pokemon
Like
circulating.
Gotta catch them all.
You really gotta understand.
Gotta catch them all.
It gets to eyes that don't want to see them.
Yo, they were so mad at me.
You understand how much mileage that gets?
And I sent them the close up one by accident. I was trying to send them the combo because he was talking to me in Spanish and then he just sent this dick pic and I was like, bro, if you watch the show you should know that I said you shouldn't send unsolicited dick pics.
You were talking to him like he had your number or your
he added me on Snap and he just flooded me with dick videos and dick pics.
It was like added dick.
That's what you get for being on Snapchat still.
Well, I like Snapchat. That's where my friends are.
Yeah, shout out Snapchat Discover.
Your friends are on Snapchat?
Yeah, like that's where we post for each other versus Instagram. Like Instagram.
So you're like, what about like,
it's like close friends on
TikTok or WhatsApp? Like you don't have none of that shit?
WhatsApp? What?
I'm like, we're in the country, bro.
Wait, what immigrant are you talking to?
No, you can can still talk
that's
to
how I talk to relatives
on.
In DR. What
you
the fuck?
Go, yeah, WhatsApp for me. That's when you out the country and.
I talk to people on WhatsApp.
For my overseas boo. What the fuck?
Okay.
Snapchat boys. The Snapchat is WhatsApp the random is. Motherfuckers. Yeah, so that's
I
why
like
you getting
Snapchat.
Dip pics. Yeah, that's why you getting dip pics.
Gotcha. All right.
All right. Anyway, long story short, please, fellas and whoever's out there, don't please. Stop it with the
Yeah, stop the dick pics, man. That's just not cool.
The fact that we have to tell people
big
to stop
dick, little
it,
dick, don't matter.
The fact that we have
I get
to
them all and I don't
how,
like
that's
them.
How sick motherfuckers are that we still have to say sick stop.
But it's like, what about like, a dick pic makes you feel like what Kaz said, what makes you feel like I'm gonna see your dick and be like, yes, where are you?
The desired reaction you're going for is never gonna
happen. It's not gonna happen.
Right. I mean,
he didn't even talk to me first.
It's a small percentage that sometimes it does.
Add it, dick.
It's a small percentage that sometimes it does.
The amount of context that you need for that to even be an opportunity is so far and few in between.
Wait, so all right, so what was the conversation like? Was there
nothing,
any inkling
he said,
of like
he started
I
it?
I want to spend another episode on this.
After I hear her answer, there were more.
That's right. It. He said, I heard on the show that you like dark skinned men.
Okay.
He said, I'm Jamaican and Dominican or something like that. Dick pic.
Oh.
And then I was like, oh, you're Jamaican? He's like, no, I'm Haitian and Dominican. I was like, another dick pic. I was like, oh, I thought you said you were Jamaican. I'm ignoring
why
the dick
are you,
pics.
But why? See, this is why you deserve this shit. Because after the first dick pic, you should have just like blocked and deleted.
There's no need for
because you're asking like, I thought you were Jamaican, but I thought you were Haitian. You're like every
I'm
response,
just
like,
all right.
another dick. Like you.
I don't
just,
want more dicks in my snap. Right,
yeah, that first one should have been boom done. First one blocked and deleted. Mm-hmm. So you brought that on yourself.
All right, let me block them.
You nasty Negroes out there, please.
Yeah, stop doing that.
Stop.
It's not okay.
What's next? Oh, this past, was it Wednesday? It was Wednesday,
Thursday.
Right? Thursday.
Yeah.
You know, if you've listened to the show for a while, you'll know that you're blessed to talk to, you know, three incredibly interesting talkers and a true athlete. You know, so as an athlete,
you are not an athlete, bro.
Shout out Foot Locker. Shout out to the Kangaroo.
I'm not in this.
Air Maxes that came out this week. Go get them a Foot Locker.
Air Max Griffey 1.
Boy Jamerson.
Yeah.
Big supporter of the show. So you're just going to throw your phone on while we talking about
it? Bro, I wasn't there, so I couldn't experience it, so I'm listening.
Okay.
You should have came.
I wasn't invited, so thank you.
It's far. You didn't want to go.
No, I'm not invited. Two of my co-hosts.
Coney Island.
That got invited to a softball celebrity match, whatever it was. Look. Didn't invite me. Didn't ask me to come cheer them on.
Oh, you're not.
None of that. So,
I didn't know.
That's cool. No,
I was
continue on.
Who the fuck wants to go to Coney Island?
If I'm with my friends, I'd love to go. Oh. And it looked like it was a fun time.
It was fucking great.
So all right. So continue on. Like
played in a great
like
celebrity. What? What are you liking?
Just pictures.
Oh, thanks. We're gonna be engaged in the conversation, Drew.
He's engaging, but not in the conversation.
So no, shout out. It was a lot of folks out there. ASAP Ferg was there.
Yeah.
Rax Brown was the captain.
Yeah.
Nigel Sylvester.
Yes.
Greg. Yuna.
Flawless.
Flawless. There's lots.
It was a lot of people there. It was fun.
Good people. Good. Bridget Kelly.
Bridget. Cheech.
Cheech. Shout out to them.
Was Schaefer there?
Schaefer was on my team.
Schaefer was there looking like a true baseball player.
Listen.
He was in his bag.
People came serious to play.
Yo.
I thought we was.
It was no bullshit.
You get those like little influencer emails or whatever. You think it's, we're going to take sweatpants. Some photos. Get some
pics. We was playing. Like,
people were going
We far. Were playing because we're all competitive.
Very. Yeah.
So
Johnny Shipes was there too, I think. Mm-hmm. He was bald.
Johnny Shipes was there? No, that was 13 Witness.
Oh, my fault. 13 Witness.
Wow.
They do look so awful.
Wow.
My bad, y'all. But he was balling for y'all. Long story short, I wasn't late because
I
had somewhere to
be. The shit started at 2. He showed up at 4:38.
About 4. Yeah, but y'all took like the first hour and a half just to do photos and warm up.
No. The first
you had a game.
No, right? The first game was your team versus the great team. I call them miscellaneous.
Which we lost.
Because y'all team was, I call them Queens and I call our team Uptown. Because everybody was from Harlem, Bronx, Washington Heights. Y'all team was mostly Queens.
Okay.
So that's what, and then the great team, we're like, we're going to call them Long Island. I don't know where the fuck they from.
Okay.
But when you were gone, they played.
Yeah.
Then Y'all sat down. Mm-hmm. Y'all had a nice little break.
Nice little rest.
Nice rest. When you got there, y'all was still resting. They rested for like 2 hours.
And I was like, yo, we were playing. Guys, shook everyone's hand, but like, yo,
yeah,
we gonna come back. We gonna win this thing, right?
So we were playing Team Miscellaneous when Cab showed up.
Yes.
So they lost. Team Miscellaneous lost, and
that was the name of the team?
No, we just don't know where they're from. We had up, we had Uptown and we had Queens.
Yeah.
It was Rox Brown's team, but they were all mixed up, so yeah, they didn't really have a.
Heard you.
So when Cash shows up, we're playing the great team. They lost. The dude announcing the shit was like, all right, Team Victorious. They said Ferg's team. He was like, Team Victorious, stay on the field. The black team is coming up. We're like, fuck.
The black team.
Yeah, because they were wearing black jerseys. But they were, no, they had some white boys.
There was some black. We had Shave.
Team champs. They were team champs.
Team champs.
Okay. Yeah.
So they come up and we're like, fuck, we can't even get a water break. Mm-hmm. They're like, stay on the field. Mm-hmm. All right, bet. They come up. We kind of cooked y'all.
Wait, you needed a water break during the softball game?
It was a 5-inning game. Okay. They were 5-inning games.
No, I'm just okay.
They were 5-inning games, and the sun was beaming.
No, I just mm-hmm. didn't know if you needed a water break during.
And it's an actual like professional field, so yeah, like, it's a lot of running around.
Big.
Right.
Like,
no, you're right.
It wasn't like the little.
The bases were short. So you get a good like line drive, you'll get a home run.
No, yeah. No, my fault. Yeah, I didn't mean to disrespect the athletes, but keep going.
Yeah, actually, as true athletes, I'm trying to show a game.
Yeah. Yeah. As an athlete as well.
So I think Rosie plays him out. You play outfield, right?
I played second.
You played second base.
I was between first and second.
Left field and center field.
Yeah.
I played left field for a little bit. Pulled my hammy a little bit. I'm in the bases. So I switched over to center field because nobody was hitting the center. I'm like, let me get center field. I got this. And then we beat y'all the first game.
Y'all beat us.
Won the first game.
But they added points.
They added. We went by points.
It went by points. So whoever had the most points, which was us and the black team, played each other. That was the.
So we went, but so
what's wait. The so whoever won the game. So
no. It wasn't like that.
Game.
Yeah.
Right. She was on Ferg's team. I was on Nigel Sylvester's team.
I was on Team Victorious. We really won, though.
And they were smacking us.
Wait, okay, hold on.
What was the score? What was the score?
Hold on. Time out. Time out.
Oh, good.
Time out. Whoever has them, y'all play by points.
Yes.
No. So what happened is,
it was a round robin tournament.
So after the second game, what happens is they go by like which team had the most runs out of both games.
Yeah.
Isn't that how baseball
no is, bro there was no. Three teams.
I guess that's why I'm not
instead
an athlete
of like when, this is
maybe that's, why. That's why I'm not an athlete and I'm an entertainer.
I'm trying to tell
y'all. Maybe that's why I'm not.
There
were
three teams. The first one was black team versus the gray team, right?
Yeah.
The second one was blue team versus the gray team,
right?
Then they add up the points, like what did they get. We had the most runs, the black team and the blue team, so we played each other.
Mm-hmm.
Which is the third game. All right, he don't
so
get
So we
it.
Got to the championship game, right? Right? And they're doing their thing.
Yo, Pablo, am I bugging?
Yeah, I'm not going to hold you. Do
he going to keep it real with you.
We didn't go by records because there were only three teams.
Yeah.
So the teams that played each other in the championship went by the people who scored the most runs.
Right, which was
is that easier to understand, low-key?
So in basketball terms, right? So in basketball terms,
the team who had the most points.
The Nets play the Knicks,
it's like
right?
Soccer. It's like soccer. That's
then
it is like
you're soccer. Making it more confusing for him. He does not know soccer.
No, I was doing basketball. The Nets play the Knicks, right? Mm-hmm. The Nets beat the Knicks.
It's not.
So then the Nets play the Celtics.
Right.
This is going deeper.
Doesn't matter who wins. They add up the points of what they got versus who won.
It doesn't make sense, though.
All right, are you all right, bro? Like, did you take animal today? Like, how's the math not mathing for you right now,
it's
bro?
Not mathing.
We scored the most
plus
runs.
One is five.
So we play each other in the chip.
Okay.
Damn it.
All right.
All right. So like I said.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay, no, I know. Okay.
So it's the first team is smoking us, right? Like, they're up by like 10-0. It was a 5-inning game.
What was the score?
It was 10-0.
It was 13-0.
That's almost mercy rule.
It was 13-0.
It was 13-0 going into the fourth inning.
Almost mercy rule.
And everybody was despondent, low, fucking upset. Just like, man, let's get over. Do we want to play the full 5 innings? Like,
yeah, one of my teammates went up to, I think it was Deli. He went up to Nigel. He was like, I mean, you could forfeit if you want to. And I just said, nah, man, that's all mental. I was like, I mean, the scoreboard is not mental, bro. What are you talking about? That's not mental. He's like, it's all cooked. Mental. I was like,
he's getting cooked. He was tired. So then I went to the huddle. I was like, nah, man, we got it. And they told us, like, yo, if you don't get one run,
life's a game of inches.
Mercy rule. Like, we lose.
Yeah.
It was 13-0 going to the fifth inning. So he's like, fuck it. Took my hats around, put on the rally hats.
What number were you?
We were all the same number. We're all 24.
Oh, okay. I put on my rally hat, flipped it upside down. I was like, fuck it. I'm just get on base, Kaz. Just get on base. They were throwing some bullshit, took a walk. I'm like, all right. Got on base. All right.
Play discipline.
Like, somebody just drop a ball. I'm running my ass home. Line drive. I'm running.
Out of breath and shit.
Athletic.
Then he starts crawling.
I start crawling across the bases. I'm like, Ryan, I need a pitch runner. Need a pitch runner, bro. I didn't realize, like, my hammies was, you know, it's not like a slim gym, bro. My tree trunks. I didn't stretch them out like I usually do. I didn't have my therapy.
You got some more thigh slappers.
You know, it's thigh slap season, so.
Oh, good.
It's really not, bro. It's really PBT. Not, bro. Like,
gross.
It's really not.
Continue.
Fans of the show know when it's...
Fans of the show love cat thighs.
They love the thighs.
Do they?
No.
Exactly.
So we just started chipping away. Then became 4-0. 4-13. Then 5-13.
Right.
Then 8-13.
Ooh.
We scored 10 runs in one inning. We get it to 10-13. You're like, all right. And I'm thinking at this point, you know what? Even if we lose, we didn't get skunked. We're not going out like some chumps. I'm all good.
Right.
Pull up Kaz's
Ferg Twitter. Gets up. Ferg hits a home run inside the Parker.
First of all, let me just say something funny about Ferg. This Ferg funny as shit, because when Ferg bats, he swings with the whole bat. So he would swing and he would do like a 360. No, he would just spin with the bat. I'm like, bro. And his girl was like, yo, control it. She's in the sideline like, control it. Stop rolling with the bat like that. First of all, when Ferg would hit a ball and he would make it, right, like nobody caught it, he would run with the bat to first. We're like, bro, drop the bat. He was like, I can't. I'm excited. He's like, I can't.
Yo, nah, he was
Ferg funny as shit. He was like, I can't. I'm excited. He was on first base with his bat. I was like, bro, let it go.
Talking hella shit.
We do. They we scored was professional a bunch shit more talkers.
Points. I think it was like 18-10 going to the bottom of the fifth.
Eesh. Yo, they scored 10 runs in one inning.
Yes.
Sweet. And that's when we knew we had a problem.
And that's when I took it personally.
So I took it personal.
We're winning this game, bro.
Can we pull up Kaz's Twitter, maybe?
So, boom, hit one. Boom, get another triple. Get the pinch runner on. Boom.
So wait, are we talking about fifth? We're in fourth.
It's fifth.
No. All right, so before going to fifth, we had a team huddle.
Oh, shit.
Clearly that shit didn't work. Up?
I'm about to say, clearly.
No.
Clearly that shit didn't work.
Before this happened. Go ahead. Go ahead.
You sure? All right. So we had a team huddle.
Because we won anyway.
So we had a team huddle, and the huddle was very simple. Get them out.
Mm-hmm. Should have been more complicated.
If they're out. No, it was simple. It was nothing about it. We got to get them out.
How'd it go?
They got to strike out. We got to get them out. And that's it. Man, listen. Out of nowhere, I'm going to tell you right now. I'm going to do this for my teammates right now. Out of nowhere, team motherfuckers player. Just got tired.
Yeah.
We missed balls that were so simple.
We were just hitting pop flies.
And motherfuckers were just like,
it was inhale.
Like, if we were so tired, we saw the ball and we were like, it's right there.
There was at least four times.
Go get it.
The game was over. That the game should have been over.
It should have been over, but we couldn't catch the balls.
Blink. Mind you, also, for the athletes listening,
also, y'all know when the sun is going down and it hits
and it's hard
certain
to see
pockets.
A little bit.
Yeah, we were tired. That sun was hitting us. I was like, it's a wrap. When we missed those two catches, I was like, it's a wrap.
I know it was over. Then I started getting my.
That's when I knew.
I was boom, hitting them joints out of here. Just. Boom, get him on base. Boom, get a triple. Boom, get a double.
Frozen ropes, baby.
I only had two runs, but listen, I was like, I want to slide so bad. That's all I wanted to do was slide. I was like, I want to slide just to get dirty.
That was the one thing you wanted to do?
Yeah.
Long story short.
It's fun.
Your boys, the champs, shout out to my team. Took the dub. Shout out to the Boys and Girls Club. Got to donate a big fat check. Anytime you could take a picture.
Man, fuck y'all.
With an oversized check. It's a good day.
First of all, did you see Nigel took it to the bar?
No, I didn't see it. I did not see that.
Nigel's a investor. You are so extra, bro. He took it with him to the bar. Greg was like, so this is what we doing? We just going to take this shit everywhere? He's like, yeah, it's my trophy. I'm like, if extra was a person, it is you.
He was probably going to take it to Biggie's last night. He's like,
Donate that shit.
That shit sounds like it was mad fun.
It was exhausting, but it was fun as fuck.
And I just want to announce that next week I'm playing in the McDonald's All-American Dodgeball Tournament.
That's fire. Sponsored. But you know what?
Sponsored by Nike.
Okay.
We're playing at Madison Square Garden.
Okay.
Oh.
Inside. Okay.
It's LeBron.
Did I get an invite?
Kevin Durant.
Ooh. He making this up.
He's just lying.
He's lying. First of all, a dodgeball tournament?
I was like
at Madison Square Garden?
I'm like, I'm pretty sure Kevin Durant's busy.
I think he's booked. I don't know.
I don't think he played the Garden either.
Dodgeball?
What's wrong with dodgeball?
I'm not playing dodgeball. That's one game I'm not playing.
I'm playing dodgeball.
I don't like it because I get really mad when I get hit.
I definitely play dodgeball.
I get pissed. No, I play with like people, but I get pissed.
Yeah.
That's one game that could easily turn to a fight.
I'm definitely playing dodgeball.
Softball sounds like
it's boring as fuck.
Softball was fun, but it was probably
because of people y'all were with.
And also, if you know the sport, it's fun.
Yeah, you know, as an athlete, I knew the sport.
Mm. As an athlete as well, I knew it.
I need to warm up a little bit. He sent a dope bit.
Yo.
I'm a big Ken Griffey fan.
So I'm a big Ken Griffey sneaker fan.
Yeah.
Not to disrespect him.
If you know the sport, like it's but like, squash or something.
No, it's like, it's because it's baseball, bro.
Baseball is not a...
It's kind of...
If you know the sport.
Where does baseball fall in your, like, pecking
order? You're also talking to the guy who didn't understand the scoring, so...
This is true.
No, because y'all doing some trickery with that shit.
I don't like what y'all was doing over there.
I don't know what kind of trickery you're
doing. I don't like with these numbers and then like round robin.
That's what happened.
I don't know what the fuck a round robin is. Like, sounds like a beer.
I don't want it.
I'm joking. Anywho,
I'm fucking
joking. But no, shout out to
I love Griffey's, man.
Shout out to Fulac.
I was excited.
Shout out to these Air Max right here. Appreciate that.
The kid.
Shout out Jamerson.
Shout out Jamerson.
First of all.
Shout out Jameson.
He was definitely like the mascot out there, just dancing every chance he got.
He damn sure was, man. It was a great time.
Yo, when I die, I want Jameson at my funeral. Cause he gonna just dance.
That took a left turn.
I want to say that got real dark.
That took a left.
Got real dark.
Is it dark?
That got real dark.
Yeah,
we don't have to.
Hey, I appreciate that though.
Also,
when
I die,
you can say your baby shower.
Don't say any drunk stories, please.
I'm saying all the
niggas. What?
All we have are drunk stories.
That's what I don't want. We're sober right now.
I'm standing on your casket and telling all these drunk stories, bro.
I don't want no. Hey,
I'm gonna raise up.
Look, my blood is here. I don't want no drunk stories. Am I okay? All right.
Y'all killed.
Maybe one or two, like the funny ones. I don't want the concussion story.
I want your
Leave that out.
To hear all these stories.
Edit the concussion story at my funeral.
Before I continue, I got breaking news.
What?
Big shout out to friend of the show, owner of the Lion's Den Barbershop, our boy Vic.
What up?
Just had a baby boy. Congratulations,
Vic.
Let's go.
I want
beautiful.
A baby.
God
damn it.
Congrats.
I need to find a baby father first.
Oh, Vic, we love
Journey,
you, baby.
That's my brother's name.
Missed the thing.
You don't need to.
I want a baby.
Husband.
No, fuck that. I want a baby. Let me ask somebody if they want to have a baby. Hold on.
Wow. All right. Congratulations.
Another portion that was about to be edited. I'm doing so good restraining myself. I'm doing a very good job. I'm so proud of myself because I almost went off the fucking roof.
Oh God,
what I was about to say.
We're gonna put you on that episode one day, yo.
We're gonna let that one loose. We have to.
I told him you did that, by the way.
We watched it back.
Why would you fucking tell him that?
Because maybe he'll listen. I don't know, but I had to.
So you told him?
I told him. I was like, yo.
And what'd he say?
He was laughing. He's a goofball.
No, you was a fucking snitch, bro.
Now I'm a snitch?
Yeah, why would you tell him that?
Because it was funny.
Yeah, to us.
It wasn't offensive. He laughed. It was funny to him, too.
So could we?
So can we do it?
Patreon.
Damn, bro.
We relaunched the page. If we ever relaunched that Patreon.
Bro, if it's not mentioned on the episode,
we're going to have a director's cut.
Keep that between the family, bro.
Man, he doesn't care. He is family.
There it is. Oh.
Yeah, no, for 6 months.
This is true. Maybe four.
Until the rotation is cleaned out.
Maybe four. I don't know.
Exactly.
Let's see how he performs.
There's that maternity leave.
Yeah. Oh, man. Yo, crazy, crazy week in the playoffs this week. NBA playoffs. Lots of games.
Also, before we go into that, I just want to let you know that I got a new pair of Air Force Ones because
thank you.
People were clowning me last week.
I'm good at that.
I can live with. You can live with a scuff. It's
no,
the bro,
no, I don't know what it is though. No, this no. Come today, no, let me talk. Hold on. I'm upset.
Blood pressure.
We need a blood pressure meter throughout the episode.
Get the solo cam.
She said, "I wouldn't date him." And now she's like, "He's got a scuff." It's like, what the fuck?
Is that what I said?
Oh, that's contact. That's contact.
Hell no. It was different.
What'd I do?
That's worse.
Nothing.
Hey, what's up?
What's wrong?
Good?
Yeah, we're good.
All right, yo. We straight.
Wow. Oh, we got poppy.
How about that touching at 30?
That man is nuts. Talking about 3-6-20. Are they dating? That touch. I was like, whoa. If reaching was a person, it's him.
You know when they play fight, you know what that means. And then,
yeah, they want attention.
I like that.
They want attention.
You didn't see that when I posted where it was like, if I talk shit to you, I might like you. I'm like,
what?
You wanna see that?
Nah.
Like, just on the way I posted it, where it was like, I've been in a toxic relationship so long, I don't even know how to flirt. I might just talk shit to you all day.
I did see that.
That's toxic.
But that sounds like you though.
That is me. I was that little girl on the playground.
It's not cute.
Push him.
Stop being toxic.
I love you.
I mean, the toxic shit is, I think, the toxic shit is like for shit and giggles on.
But
it's real life.
Mean that though.
Yeah. Mm.
They're like, it's not.
I'm glad I've never.
It's easy to not change.
Yeah. I don't
women
think
women
like,
want to hurt you.
It's like better myself.
Wow. They just want to hurt you?
That's not.
No, not just.
No, it's like, not all women don't.
No, not all.
It's like, confront my past.
For what?
Better myself.
That's everybody though. That's
get like out of here. What? Take me as I am.
The toxic shit is what everybody does.
Let's just be toxic. It's fun.
Sometimes it's just easier. Not say it like.
Oh.
Sometimes it's easier.
This took a turn.
No. I'm saying like sometimes it's easier for people not to confront their bullshit and their.
It's always easier to not have to confront shit.
I think it's easier, but in the long run.
That's what I'm saying. For some people, it is easier because it's a consistent routine of what they've been doing.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
So it's not reconstructing your ideas or how you deal with people or, you know, the trauma you've dealt with. So the niggas is like, yo, fuck it. Like, I'm just going to keep this path.
Yeah.
And that's it. Wow. So for some people, it's easier.
Couldn't do it, man. Yeah. Listen. Growth.
I'm sure you've had toxic moments.
Oh,
absolutely. Yeah, you're talking about, I couldn't shit. Do it. Absolutely. Couldn't no, be me.
Now.
It's growth. You know what we call that? Growth.
Yeah.
That's what we're doing.
Don't roll your eyes.
As the most toxic motherfucker on this show?
Probably.
Currently. I'm sure you guys have been more toxic than me.
I've definitely been.
Oh, yeah, I have, yeah.
Exactly. Retract that statement.
I definitely have.
I'm just the current toxic.
Currently, you're the current, you know, MVP of toxic. Toxic.
Listen, whatever. But that's single me. When I'm in a relationship, it's different.
But my city.
Toxic. I'm future.
In my city. I'm
about to lock my hair.
Disorder.
I was thinking about you. How's your mom doing?
I don't want to expose my age.
It's been a minute. I know Father's Day.
How old I am right now.
You didn't know the System of a Down record I was singing just now?
No, I know. No, I know what you're talking about.
I don't know the words, but I know the melody.
When angels deserve to.
No?
Sweet Caroline, everybody has like that level of white records. They only got like
yo,
five.
Yo, you know what I wanted to ask y'all? I'm so glad y'all picked this.
I had to break that out.
I wanted to ask y'all this, and I thought about it during the week because I was thinking about random questions to ask because I don't know why.
Okay.
What is a record like that, like a guilty pleasure record?
Oh my god!
That you're you shouldn't be listening to, but you thoroughly enjoy it.
I don't want to say I shouldn't be listening to this.
Like, yeah, but you like, know, people would look at you weird. Like, why are you singing this like this and so happy about it?
I have a playlist.
Is it like a Miley Cyrus song? Like something like that?
I'm not
like,
gonna hold you. I have a playlist.
Like that America song she got. If you was listening to that, I would look at you different.
Listen,
I have a playlist called "Low." You listen to this.
I love.
And that's literally the conversation we're having right now. I'm going to pull up the records right
Please,
now.
Pull up some
records. Go ahead.
I'll tell you some of my records.
Where is it?
And it's not even a guilty pleasure. I don't feel guilty about it.
But I'm asking for, there's one song that you listen to that you're like.
I personally love white people bar ballads. Like, I love those type of records. I like Living on a Prayer comes on.
That you know.
Hold on.
We got.
Don't get me started.
Though, because you know I worked at bars, so I love that kind of shit.
That's like
you
heard that shit every night.
Every fucking night. God forbid there was a jukebox where I worked. Oh no.
All right, so I got.
I used to lock it up when real white people came in. I'd be like, no jukebox.
I have Churches, Never Ending Circles.
You don't just read the song, sing it, motherfucker.
Well, no, I can't sing it.
You can't sing it?
Well, I just know like what I hear.
I mean,
some people might know the artists. What I'm saying, Holy Child, Running Behind.
Miley Cyrus.
Locking my hips like
everybody.
Taking my head like you listen to that at home? Exactly. That's a guilty pleasure. Like if I walked in y'all crib and y'all are listening to this, I'm like,
at home?
Party in the USA.
You listen to that at home?
I listen to it a lot. You'd be surprised the shit I blast in the crib.
I'm not listening to that at home.
That's a guilty pleasure, Cass, because you shouldn't be listening to that at home.
I ain't listening to
Imagine
that.
Imagine big ass Cass walking around talking about.
Big black ass Cass.
Thinking in my hips like, yeah. Thinking in my hips like, yeah. No. Bro, that's not okay.
You know what my current.
There's a Taylor Swift song.
Oh shit!
What's the Taylor Swift song?
Sheryl Crow too.
That I do like.
What's the Sheryl Crow song I like?
Is it Sheryl Crow? No, Alanis Morissette.
Alanis Morissette.
Oh, Iron and his
Vanessa Carlton.
Jam. It's already late and no smoke inside.
Y'all niggas know
on
a lot
your
of
break.
Mm-hmm. Y'all know a lot of white. On Juneteenth, y'all singing these white folk songs.
You know what?
On Juneteenth, y'all singing these white folk songs.
Don't you think? A little too ironic. And yeah, No, you know, I got one. I got a guilty pleasure.
What?
Because my music range is very wide, right? Because I'm Dominican and my dad was a musician and I like this shit, I like that. So it's wide.
Okay.
But there's a Hootie and the Blowfish song.
Hootie and the Blowfish was my favorite.
That's not a guilty pleasure.
That's a guilty pleasure because it's like people look at you like.
No. Hootie and the Blowfish were dope.
No, no,
I only want to be with you.
Fuck that.
Bro, they had a black singer.
Only one of you. Nah, fuck
that.
No,
I do.
No, here's the song. And I know we're going off on the rails right now.
As long as you don't know the words, as long as you just hit them with the
melody. I do. When it comes on, I remember all the words.
Only one of you. But you gotta sing the chorus with your.
Remember the song from Eurotrip?
Scotty doesn't know. Yo, we're dumb.
He killed that.
Nah, we are dumb.
That was Matt Damon, right?
Yeah.
What about Boats and Hoes? Boats and Hoes.
That was from
Step Brothers. Boats and Hoes. Boats and Hoes. Over. I was like, yeah.
There's so many songs from like fucking movies that should have been real ass songs.
You know what?
I love dumbass comedy like that.
I loved Together. the boy band from MTV. Y'all remember Together?
No.
You plus me equals us.
What?
I know my calculus. You know the record, dog.
No, nigga, you're the only one in here.
Nobody knows say it. Don't spread it. I want
to. Is that like a parody or something?
Could you be any whiter?
How do you know?
Could
this
you
like
be any whiter?
Yeah, like, how do you know?
I grew up in Staten Island, goddammit.
It's showing, bro.
For those who don't know,
nobody knows except you.
At the height of the boy band phenomena in the early 2000s, MTV put together a
phenomenon. Not phenomenon.
Something like a phenomenon.
Phenomenon.
Something like a phenomenon.
It's not phenomena.
Oh, man. Anyway, people in the comments know Together. That was my shit.
No, they don't.
I bet you.
Yo, they don't. Nigga, we don't know it.
Tweet. Go on Twitter right now.
I'm not. Bro, you do it.
Just tweet you plus me equals us. Watch your replies. Just watch your replies.
No, because bitches going to be gone. They're going to think I'm in love again.
No, motherfuckers are going to say, oh, I know my calculus.
Nobody's going to say that, Cass.
Bro, like, no one's going to like.
Nobody, because
no one's going to say that.
No.
Like, no one's going to be like, nobody. Oh, no, no, together. You. Like, that's not going to be.
Me. Equal sign.
Like, yo, if I tweet that shit, niggas gonna be looking at me like, yo, bro,
Cass,
it's Saturday.
Take a nap, bro.
It's Juneteenth. Go outside.
Jake, you don't remember Together?
No.
The boy band? Oh,
nobody. No.
You know for damn sure he's not gonna remember.
Oh my.
You know for damn sure.
He's not. Hey. None of us. Yo,
you're tripping.
You're bugging.
Together.
Go
hold on.
And watch it. Listen to the song.
Nah, son, you good.
Get a chance.
Man. Together. Song by Kirk Franklin. That ain't it. Good
fit. Oh.
It's not that one.
It ain't that one.
Number
family.
Two, okay? Not T-O.
No, it's Pergola Open.
Together. Damn it. You wanna hang?
All right, get
together,
okay. All right, all right. Let's go.
You
let's,
and me
let's talk
forever.
About the playoffs. Let's
yeah,
talk
you
about
guys have predictions.
Together, I don't. Do you have any
crazy weekend in the playoffs?
It is a crazy.
Yo, you have predictions.
Don't call it a comeback.
Don't call it a comeback. You know what I mean? I think that was the theme of the week, being down 13 runs,
yes.
Being down 25 points.
Stop putting yourself in that. Like, stop putting yourself in that. Stop putting it. It was softball. It was softball. It was softball.
The mentality it takes. Yes, yes, yes. Play
yo,
that shit.
Yo, the fact that this is what Kaz was singing. Yo, guys, please Google Together and look at these motherfuckers.
Yes. Yes.
Yo, Kaz.
Calculus is as you plus me equals us. Oh, you gotta watch it. If you don't watch, listen. If I do anything on this podcast,
that guy said you
plus me equals us. Yo, I know my calculus.
I hate calculus. All right, let's go.
My algebra and trigonometry. It doesn't equal up to what you do to me.
I'm telling you this right now. I'm telling you this right now.
Shout out Mickey Park.
I'm telling you this right now.
Bro, what is wrong with you?
When whatever happens on Monday.
This is what wrestling fans do. Listen, if you like wrestling, you do shit like this.
Listen to me. Listen to me fucking closely. Whatever happens on Monday, we're not talking about this shit.
No, we are. We are.
God,
we are.
Damn it.
Oh, my
yo,
God.
Yo, what is wrong with you?
Playoffs before we get out of here.
Playoffs. Here.
Woo. The playoffs, Madden cover, yeah. You know what I mean? Brady and Mahomes, which is dope. But let's talk about these playoffs. I feel like a lot of folks were very skeptical about the interest in the playoffs because of not a whole lot of like familiar names like LeBron.
Like Steph, Curry and Bron. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
You had, a lot of injuries that kind of.
You got COVID.
You know, sullied a lot of things.
Chris Paul with COVID.
Chris Paul thing happening.
Yeah.
You know, and even with all that. Uh-huh. Even with all of those things that could derail many other seasons, especially after the ones we just had, these games these past week have been
last night
nuts.
Yo, last night, just last night, even though the Clippers won by 10, but like that fourth quarter stretch of them going back and forth, back and forth, that shit was insane.
It was like some NBA Jam shit.
Yeah,
like,
and it was
Jordan Clarkson going nuts, Donovan Mitchell going nuts, and Terrence Mann of all people going nuts. PG, like not playing like Pandemic P again, like
Playoff P.
Playoff P came back, you know.
The last two games he was on his shit.
Listen,
he's hey, also shouts to Reggie Jackson. Reggie Jackson, last game, pulled up. Reggie Jackson and
Marcus Morris are like, they've always been like steady hands, you know what I'm saying? So like, it's good that people are starting to like see them blow up in these sort of moments. Yeah. It's been incredible.
And I have to, it's hats off to the Clippers because they performed very well without Kawhi.
I have a question for Kaz.
What's the question?
How you feel about the Nets almost?
Oh, it's game seven tonight?
Yeah.
So here's the
thing. How you feel about this?
8:30? By the time, it's
8:30. First of all, what do you think about that?
Because
I'm actually glad it's going to game seven.
But
it can go either way, so I don't know how to
preface it. Because by the time this comes out, it'll be Monday. We'll know who is going to the Eastern Conference Finals, whether it's the Brooklyn Nets, Milwaukee Bucks. If the Brooklyn Nets go there, I gotta admit, there's parts of me that's
still happy about it because it's New York, kind of
rooting a little bit for the Brooklyn Nets.
Yeah, because it's still New York.
It's still New York.
But we knew it would come down to this.
Mm. And I, as just a fan of good hoops, I can't look at a dude like Giannis, who is extremely accomplished, extremely dominating,
who has no bag,
but isn't aesthetically pleasing as a dude who is right on the other side of that team, same sort of frame, same height, that can do everything and has had to do everything.
Who are you talking about, KD?
Kevin Durant. Right? Yeah. So it's like, you know, it's easy to not root for the Brooklyn Nets when they got the super team all together and Kyrie's hooping and James Harden's hooping. And the reason why, and I think this is what a lot of people, I feel like the reason why people didn't really rock with the Brooklyn Nets as a team is because it felt like there'd be no competition. It felt like they was going to just run away with everything. And it was just like, why?
Injuries plagued them.
Injuries happen.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? And now you start to see why they're a super team in the first place. Right. It's like, even without
Kyrie
Irving, even with James Harden on a bad leg, even with like a bunch of spare parts that they just kind of put together, Kevin Durant still just like,
he's that dude.
We're going. You know what I'm saying? Like that game. Game five in Brooklyn when he had 49, I think 17 rebounds, 11 assists.
He showed up, bro. He showed up.
He didn't just show up.
Like
that was one of the best playoff performances
I've ever seen. He played the whole game, right?
How many points?
49.
Game five?
Yeah, yeah, like 49 points.
49 points.
Missed
on 23 shots. Efficient.
That's ridiculous.
We're giving it to every
ratio is ridiculous. Insane.
Everybody.
So were they all threes?
Got it.
Were they all threes?
He put up like 30.
I ain't the best at math, but shit.
And they said that. They said that, you know, when Kyrie went down. And they were like, yo, that next game, KD is going to like, he has to score 40.
But that's what KD
They said it. They were like, yo, he has to score 40.
I think it's been so long that we've got to see KD just
be KD.
Just dominate.
Without like superstars next to him. Yeah. Without like the Currys and the Westbrook and the Hardens. Yeah. And
nobody outshining him.
It's been a long, like a deceptively long time. Like even when you think back to his Thunder days, he still had Russell Westbrook. He still had like James Harden on the come up.
Serge.
He still had Serge Ibaka. Like it was the first time in a long time we got to just see KD just be like, yo, here's the ball.
Go do it.
Take us to the promised land. And you saw Steve Nash hug that motherfucker like, said everything I needed to know, where it was just like,
Thank you.
I don't know what I'm doing. Thank you for saving my ass, you know? So if
I want to say something so bad about that hug, but I don't want to be too.
So if the Brooklyn Nets do win with, you know, Kevin Durant's heroics, more power to them.
Yeah.
Does Giannis
but
lead
if
the
they
Bucks?
Lose, if they lose.
What happens if they lose?
I don't think they get the criticism.
I don't think it's heavy.
I think they do.
So much is expected from them because of their roster.
Yes.
So then when you have they lose, they're gonna be like, wow, how you lose with KD, James Harden, Kyrie? How you lose?
You had two of your star players go down.
Right.
You made it to this is semifinals, right?
Yeah, he's the conference semis. Yeah,
it's the semis.
Yep.
You took them to game seven without two of your star. One and a half stars.
Well, they went down game four, I think, right?
Kyrie went down game two.
Okay, but Harden went down game four and came back.
Mm-hmm. Right, so he was like
out 6 weeks.
No, he came back game three. I'm bugging.
Yeah, so it's like I don't think they get the hugest critique.
The reason, but why the thing is, people don't think about that. They don't care about that. They're still gonna talk shit.
Right.
It's New York.
I don't even think it's talking shit. I think it's like this. You gotta think of the whole context, right? Like, they'll be going into the year three.
Bro, they deserve shit. They deserve shit.
They're going into year three of this experiment, right? Kevin Durant. They signed Kevin Durant fresh off an injury. You know what I mean? Blown Achilles. He's come back, obviously.
Right.
But they were willing to roll the dice and be like, yo, take that year off and recover. You know what I'm saying? Like, and get right.
Yeah.
And obviously, and it's paid off.
Like, right.
He's just good. As good as he's ever been.
Right.
Good. And if you don't win, now it's like, okay, we're going into year three. Kevin Durant's going to be a free agent pretty soon again. So is Kyrie Irving.
Well, I mean, I think it's year two for
no,
Kevin.
It's year two of playing, but like he's
year three of like
a three
on the books.
Yeah. Yes. Yeah.
Okay.
So it's like, if you're a lot of folks who really were actual Brooklyn Nets fans, I know, like before the super team thing, they're going to start thinking like, well, we blew up this team of, you know, this fun young D'Angelo Russell, Jared Dudley, like Caris LeVert, Spencer Dinwiddie. They were a fun, exciting young team. And if you're going to get the same results that you got with three surefire Hall of Famers and don't have no draft picks, really,
for all,
your money's tied up into those dudes and you don't and you're not. You make these moves to win championships, period. It's not to have a good showing. It's not to be like, oh, we gave it a good try. Like, the Knicks get away with that stuff. When you got three dudes on that team, it's championship or bust. And that's how they should carry themselves. That's how they have carried themselves.
No, I got you.
So, I mean, I think it'll be good for Giannis because I think he gets a lot of shit for having no bag and not having really like a whole lot of wiggle.
Has but no to be
bag,
fair,
it's no bag. It's so he does not the same fun to watch him play ball.
He does the same move. I'm like, oh, bro, are you? This is what you. That's it.
Hitting that R2, like
R2.
Yo,
that's all you got, my nigga. Like, damn, like, yo, give me a triangle, give me an X, give me like something, bro.
It's like you're watching him and like he really can't shoot that well and like he's still trying to shoot. I mean, unlike Ben Simmons, like I don't know where that sort of lies. Like when it comes to Ben Simmons,
bro, he took four shots.
Oh my god.
In game six. Four shots.
Ben?
At what point do you have to trade?
He was
Ben?
2 for 4 for the field goal.
I don't think Ben Simmons, that's
irresponsible to me.
Yeah.
What?
I mean, to go 2 for 4, to only take 4 shots in a game
so
six.
Here's my thing with Ben Simmons, right? Everyone's so big on him, like, yo, you got to shoot more. You got to hit shots. And I don't think you don't have to shoot jump shots.
You don't have to hit shots.
You just got to be aggressive. Like, look at Giannis. Like, Giannis.
That's one thing I would say about Giannis. Giannis is very aggressive.
He will be aggressive. He can't shoot for shit, but he's going to go down shooting.
Yeah.
Ben Simmons is like, he's allergic to a jump shot. Like, he's not even going to try. Yeah. To do it.
How the fuck he assigned then?
How do you go that long?
Yeah.
6'10, super athletic. Like, how do you look at God in the face? Be like, yo, thank you for making me 6'10 and super athletic. I'm not going to work on my jump shot. Like, how do you do
bro,
that?
Bro, you make me 6'10, light skin, athletic. I'm in that gym every fucking day.
We have J. Cole trying to go to fucking Africa working on his jump shot.
A nigga has 6 albums out.
Get your shit together, Ben Simmons.
Still found the time to work on his jump shot.
Exactly.
And you're paid millions.
And you don't want to work on it?
You're in a game six?
You're a max contract player. And I feel bad for this because I have been a Ben Simmons apologist for a long time. As people who like watch basketball a lot, it's like you see all the good he does in the game.
Yeah.
So it's hard to sit him, but... It's hard to keep playing a dude.
But he's also a defensive monster as well. No,
exactly.
But he's like, an offensive liability.
He's an offensive liability, bro. Yeah. And then you got to do like Trae Young, who's like a buck 60 soaking wet, running circles around dudes. And of course, he's a great defender. Probably could have been defensive player of the year.
Yeah.
And with all that, Trae Young is still figuring it out. I'm a witness, bro. I got to give it up to that dude, bro.
I'm a witness, man. He is.
I talked hella shit. I talked about him twerking for free throws.
Hey,
I talked about him in his hair.
That man walked into the Garden and tore y'all apart. Yeah. My man bowed.
Man, listen.
I've
seen a lot of shows in the Garden, bro. I seen Jordan come through there.
54, 55.
I seen
Reggie
come through there. I seen Bron.
9 points in 8 seconds.
I seen all these guys come through the Garden on regular season games. What separates these dudes is what they do in the playoffs. Mm-hmm. Is what makes them. And I got to tip my hat to that dude, bro.
Because I thought Trey was going to do it again last night.
He almost did.
With that fadeaway three, I'm like, shit, it's about to start.
And I'm just looking at the dude. I'm like, yo, he's a different breed. Like, I talked a lot of crap.
He's different.
I talked Trey a lot Young of crap is. To Atlanta fans because, you know, it's the Eastern Conference playoffs are fun because I feel like I know somebody.
It's like for our friends and our Twitter friends.
A ton of Philly friends.
You got to think about Steve-O, who's an ATL fan. Corey Towns.
Shout out Steve-O, man.
Steve-O was talking big shit.
Steve-O had me hot.
Yo, Steve-O, and I'm not even a Philly fan, but Steve-O was like, I'm like, yo, how you talking crazy like that? I'm like, nigga, I don't even like the Sixers. I'm like, yo, bro, you're not going to be talking to niggas like that.
I was hot.
Nah, Steve-O was talking his shit.
But, yo, it's been fun, though, because it's like, it's all like the populated areas of the East Coast. Yeah. Like Atlanta, Philly, New York, Brooklyn, you know what I mean? Milwaukee. Yeah.
That's Midwest.
Miscellaneous.
But you know, the Clippers are still in it, you know what I mean? Yeah, so it's like, for all it's worth, for all the BS that like the NBA has gone through this past year.
It's fun, it's been fun.
And there's still big markets in there. Like they still got,
and like I'm not even
the possibility of that New York LA finals.
I'm not even gonna hold you. Like this is like the most playoffs that I've watched in a long
time.
Yeah, I skipped basketball last year.
Yeah, like I watched the finals and like
that's what I skipped it last year. I skipped all of it. I was like, fuck it.
Even
not watching
a bubble
is
a once in a one on one experience, and like it's not an asterisk to me because it was definitely a difficult thing to go through. You can't replicate going into someone's house, have 20,000 people
coming out of the tunnel,
going through the tunnel, going through, you know. When,
now you're right. You're right.
You can't replicate
and
that.
And it's the energy, but, too. Like, I feel like the
atmosphere.
The players feel that.
Yeah.
And like you said, there's a home advantage as well.
Of course. It's like,
of course.
So tonight's in Brooklyn?
And I see it. Like, I see the players.
I'm going to stay inside tonight.
I see the players, like, asking for the reactions. I see the players igniting the crowd.
Off of it.
Yeah, so when you're in the bubble, like
calling your crowd the sixth man isn't just like a nice marketing ploy. Like they, like you talk to actual basketball players when they're tired, when they don't got it, hearing that roar, hearing that silence.
Yeah.
Like when you could silence 20,000 people, like that's another.
And that's what happened to us at the softball game. We didn't have the energy and we had no fans to be like, let's go, team.
Listen. We were
I was the hype man.
We were the fan favorite.
And when I started dying, the team started dying.
We was down by 10. We got the fans behind us. Like, it definitely shifted.
Why you was jumping off ropes?
No.
What happened?
Why was you jumping off ropes?
Hey, don't touch your timestamp it.
Excuse me. I could have been cheering y'all on, but I wasn't invited. So.
Oh, well.
Well, who are you going to cheer on?
We're different teams. Hey, look.
Both hands.
The winner.
Rosie Cass. Like,
well, you could have just cheered for the winner.
First of all, buddy, y'all were about to lose.
Well, about to.
Motherfuckers. We really won, though.
Almost is only counting the horseshoes.
Almost on count.
Anywho,
I said, why were you jumping off ropes? That looked weird.
Yeah, wait, you were doing athletic shit this week.
I was very athletic.
That's why you pulled your hammy. It was the ropes, not the game.
I came right from there too. Like, I was running the ropes. I was jumping off the top rope.
Is it really hard?
Is it hard? First off.
That's what she said.
Wrestler.
Way to be mature, Lo.
I know you're not talking.
Yeah. I've been a wrestling fan my whole life, right?
We could tell by your music choice.
You give me what?
Ooh. A wrestling fan is all life.
What's my music choice got to do with being a wrestling fan?
It's a white barb music?
Oh, what?
All right. Continue.
We can talk about how he dresses.
Anyway.
That's
what we're doing. Right back at it. Free my friend.
Shut up. Now, you know TJ be in the comments, our TJ, he was like, why that guy low-key never takes his hat off?
Before we go on, I went home this weekend to see my dad. We had an early Father's Day dinner and everything. So
yeah.
I was like, I went, did a little shopping. So I'm like, damn, like my barber's still there from like when I was in high school.
Mm-hmm.
His name is Hassan. So I was like,
have you been getting this cut since you were in high school?
Middle school.
First off, brother. Get off. Take your hat off.
You got hair to cut.
You got hair?
These are warm, bro.
Yo, Jake said hashtag wear your kicks. Yes.
No, white people can pull that off.
White people.
Old rich Jewish white people can pull that off.
They can just wear the dirtiest.
No, you're old and you're Jewish and you're rich.
I'm Jewish, I'm white. I'm not rich.
Or old.
Listen, we're old, yeah.
You look at it all. He looks old.
Wow.
How old are you?
25.
Exactly. Really? He's not old. Yeah.
You're 25?
You know white people don't age well. Sorry.
Wow. I wasn't even going there. Like, bro, I wasn't even trying to go there. Okay, cool.
Why'd you say like that?
You know white people age like Bill. It's just
I wasn't even trying to do that. Yeah, I wasn't even trying to take it there, Jake.
Guess what? We were all thinking it.
No. I wouldn't say it.
You said it, but you were thinking it.
Nah, he don't look. No, he doesn't look old. Anyway, so I went to my you're fine. So I went to my old barber. He was there since high school, and they still have a shop there. So I went there. I was like, yo, you know what? I'm gonna go get a cut. So I walked in, and then my man, his name is Hassan. He looked at my beard. He was like, yo, who's been shaving your shit?
You're like me.
I was like, obviously, because I haven't been in a barbershop.
You're like me. He's like, duh.
He was like,
so you haven't found a new home barber?
I do, but I just don't try.
Go to the Dominicans. Come uptown.
No, there's one literally right across from my building. Okay. But I just, they're either on vacation or they're closed. So I stopped it. So
you're home, right?
Yeah, I'm not. Yeah, I'm not.
You should hit, what you call? What's it?
I know there's shops. They're open now. Like
Gotcha.
So I go in there. He's like, yo, who's been shaving your beard? I was like, it's me. He was like, yeah, nigga, stop. He was like, stop doing your own shit.
Leave it alone.
He was like, nigga, it's up over here and it's down over here. I'm like. I'm like, no one told me on the show that my shit was looking crazy.
He said, yeah, stop.
Let me tell you something.
Bro, I'm taking a trip back to New Brunswick every fucking Thursday night, Friday morning to get this shit done. Because I've been missing this. Like, look how clean.
I was going to say, look clean up today.
Yeah, it looks good.
Look at my man.
But let me tell you something.
What, cuz?
As a black man, and the black men that listen to this show.
Can't relate.
Too.
Or maybe I can.
Me neither.
When you're having those conversations with your barber,
edited comment.
Those conversations with your barber, you never want to have that conversation with him, bro. Small talk is nice. But there's one or two or three things that what your barber does that makes your heart sink to your ass, bro. if your barber sits down and he does one of these, this is the head, puts the cape around him, and he does one of these.
Yo, he's basically what the fuck am I gonna do with this?
You been doing? What the fuck you been doing the last 6 months?
Why you let your pops cut your hair?
It's like handing somebody born in the 2000s an actual map and be like,
find your way.
Take their phone, give them a map. Does he spin you too?
Oh my god.
He spins you and be like, project.
Okay.
It's a project though. They like it.
Bro. Listen, they like the challenge. You never want to be the challenge though.
The reason why I didn't take it as disrespect, because he's a jokester. This nigga he's a clown.
Yeah.
So I knew when I got in the chair, I knew it was coming. Because I just felt it. I'm just looking at
Did y'all see the clip that was...
I'm not even done telling the story.
Okay, go ahead.
Ooh, got it. Hey, let them
have it.
Shut up, bitch. Hey, yo. Damn.
Hard.
Hey,
hey,
oh,
well,
shut up, bitch.
Shut up, bitch. Don't like, speak unless spoken to.
All
right, God damn it.
How dare you speak out of turn?
All right, shit.
It's like, what year is this? Can't believe they let you vote.
What are you doing here?
You have rights.
Take the mic from her. God damn it.
No, my fault, my fault. All right, here goes more time.
Don't tell
more time.
At what time stamp?
13. No, but like, just to wrap it up, like, it's just like, it felt good to be back and like in that chair, like with your barber, like,
yeah,
you know, like just the
nostalgic
jokes.
Right?
Yeah, it's nostalgic. Like, we were watching movies, we was cracking jokes.
How long was his haircut?
What's up with you today, bro?
I was saying, like, if you watch the whole movie,
like,
it's
that movie?
Hey, yo, Jordan, what time we got? How much time we got? Like, cause like I'm trying to get off a sentimental moment.
When we do the low stress meter,
we need to do that.
Has to be a marker with low sense. Yo, how much time we got?
Yeah. He does it every episode.
How much time we got?
Once I hit that, I'm done. Like, I'm done.
Are we out?
I was trying to bring it home, and then like fucking.
We watch movies. How many movies did y'all watch? You don't got much work.
Let's talk about the playoffs. Like, well, okay, the Suns and the Clippers. All right, that's what's up. Yeah, happy Father's Day. Cool, whatever.
It was a great shout out to dads.
Like, you know, I'm pissed off.
We know. What are you not?
I'm trying to like make a sentimental moment. Like, hey, Jake is rocking with me. Like, yo, like,
I'll try to let you cook.
No, when I got the juice on my side.
Yeah, hey, bro, you can't lose.
I just wanted to know. I was just curious.
I was just talking about what we was doing in the shot.
How long? Why are y'all watching movies?
We were watching a movie.
Oh, one movie. Okay.
Yes, we didn't watch
the whole thing.
Well, 30 minutes. 25 minutes of it.
Yo, what genre?
It was the action.
Is it good?
I couldn't see the whole thing. Was it good?
Was it highly recommended?
Was it Bad Boys 2? That was my favorite action
Bad
movie.
Bad Boys 2, yeah. It was definitely Bad Boys
2. Was it Marvel?
Yeah, if I don't get paid, this show, I'm quitting. I go through too much shit. I go through too much shit when I try to, like, open my heart up to y'all niggas. Like,
open my heart up? I was
literally just saying it felt good to be back in my barber's chair after the pandemic was over and we were having a good time. We were talking about family shit. We were talking about life shit. We was watching a movie and I looked good and I just wanted to tell you guys because I wasn't with you this weekend because you had the celebrity softball tournament that I wasn't invited to. Mm-hmm. So I wanted to tell you something that you weren't a part of that I was a part of. Is that so fucking hard? And I hate your fucking
ear. Talk your shit, King.
Well, I have new Air Force. Bro. I have new Air Force Ones.
low.
Foot Locker, hit him up.
Yo, we do need a stress meter.
We do.
We need a low-key blood pressure meter.
That. Please stop doing that.
No,
bro.
Never.
It's okay, bro.
Please what would we do that for?
Please stop. Relax. Just stop.
Can I see how the straws? Oh, yo, shout out to Fly Rye.
Shout out Ryan, bro.
Yo, he got these straws. Well, they're right. You have one. I only had one.
Yeah, shout out.
But let's see how it's doing. Is it?
Still going strong.
Oh, shit, for real?
Yeah, hasn't.
Guys, so Fly Rye has these straws, which we all hate paper straws, right? Because they melt. Is it called melting? I don't know, but they go limp.
They get a little dissolvey.
They get limp, and it forces you to drink faster. I think that was the whole point of the thing.
You got a lot of DMs you didn't answer.
I know.
Wow.
Hey,
you.
Yeah, my phone,
lingering though. Eyeballs, bro.
Right in my phone, dog. Yeah, I am saying. No, don't. We not opening none of that. Okay.
Slide.
But I'm glad he makes these because I hate those paper straws, bro.
It has a terrible taste and it makes it not fun because.
And then you try to flip it when it starts getting like soggy or like whatever you call it. Like, you try to flip it and you're like, I can't.
It's like tissue.
Bro. It's weird.
We support Black business on Say Less, so shout out Guy Ryan.
We do support
got
Black business.
Straws, those Ecolabs.
They are going strong.
I'll tell you one thing, Abby Solo, come back over here.
Strong.
Cheers, Abby Solo.
Cheers, Abby.
Stay far the fuck away.
Yes, sir.
Come back over here.
Yes, sir. They got a new Madden cover this week. Tom Brady, Patrick Mahomes.
That was real.
That was a real cover. Yeah, two goats, baby goat.
Two white boys.
Yeah, first two. Well,
no, they're not.
It's actually one and a half white boys.
Yeah, it's one and a half.
Yeah, you got drafted.
First off.
Oh, yeah, he did.
This is true.
No, that's very true.
We do need a new racial draft, by the way. I think we need
next season.
We need a new one. So
next season.
Yeah.
Wait, like the end of summer?
Something.
After the finals, you know, some people might make.
We might need to drop some people.
We might need to drop some people. Some people may need to.
The
be
Jews definitely upgraded. Need to drop some people.
Wow. All right. Okay. I'm gonna let that one slide.
They're fucking up.
I'll let that one sail out of bounds.
I'm saying
it. I didn't hear it.
I didn't say it. That nigga said. I mean, that man.
Another racial draft soon.
We still got the accents though.
Excuse me.
The what?
The Drake accents. First of all, did y'all see Drake at the basketball game?
Brought this up.
All right.
That was Amiri. What's his name? Amiri.
Shout out Sierra Canyon. That was Amiri.
Yeah, he went to the Sierra Canyon game, right?
No. But we all know why he was really there.
We know why he was there.
We're not gonna do that. We're not gonna do that.
We know why.
Can we pull up some of that footage?
Amari's mom.
No. Don't disrespect. Don't.
That's why he was there.
Don't do that. Don't do that.
She's fire. I'd be there too.
Don't do that.
I just can't sit next to her because I'm not Drake.
Pull up that
footage of Drake, Michael B. Jordan.
Yeah.
Don't do that.
At the Sierra Canyon basketball.
Michael B. Jordan was not there for that, but Drake was.
No, Michael B. Jordan was there.
No, but he wasn't there for that.
Guys, be respectful.
We know why
be
Drake was there.
Be respectful.
How are we being disrespectful?
No, I don't. Because I know. Because I saw. Like, yeah. All right. So like, this is just me. Like, I'm not trying to be like whatever. I'm just. Mm-hmm. I don't want. Because like that kid is popular. Like Amiri is very
top recruit.
Top recruit.
Probably gonna be in the NBA very soon.
I don't want. I don't want that.
I've commentated a lot of his games. I watched them for a long time.
So I don't want that. I don't want that situation. I don't want that thing. Because like we know how Drake is. We know what Drake does. Like Drake is, you know, he's sniper. He's a sniper. We know, like,
Oh, you know Aubrey?
I don't know Aubrey personally. Bro,
we know Aubrey. Aubrey's gonna snipe.
I do nothing but just.
He's a sniper.
We know he's a sniper. So I don't want
a man life. All I know is he was at a game.
But like
a highly touted basketball game.
And what are we talking about? We're not talking about the game.
He was sitting next to.
Exactly.
There you go. All right. This is the semifinals.
Yeah.
This is with Bronny James.
That's when Bron
was there.
That was the first game when Bron and Drake were there.
Yo, that's a killer duo right there.
Oh.
Yeah, Lil Bronny.
Amari and Bronny?
Yeah, Bronny going to be a problem, too.
Bronny's already a problem.
Yeah, that was the first game they went to.
Dude got big out of nowhere.
Look at Bron. Bron is the dad that you want at every game.
Yeah.
He out there talking shit.
You saw the meme where Drake and LeBron were talking, and you saw Savannah looking over the shoulder, and he was like, Savannah was like, that nigga better not be asking to spend a night again.
Tell me you gotta go home.
But yeah,
shout out to Brown.
It should be on the Balls Life Instagram somewhere. But yeah,
no, it's the most recent one.
It was like two days ago.
But anyway, yeah, lots of talk about this man's mom because you know
she's fire.
She's a mom.
And, but yeah, still leave it alone.
Keep it there.
Just leave it alone. just leave it alone.
That's not, but leave it alone. Find it. Instagram salutes. Go ahead and find it. And
I have a very sensitive sweet spot for like
family relatives. I've learned firsthand. Yeah. Yep. Got you. Yep.
Leave that alone.
Yep.
Especially when it comes to like celebrities and like
say less.
Because she wasn't niggas didn't even know about her before like this.
Nah. I mean, probably
first
not
of all,
mainstream.
Yeah, no, like, people so now, like, knew.
People like, know who she is.
People like, knew like, because the comments were literally when they posted it. The comments were, he was there for Amari's mom. Like everybody said that.
No, she's been to games with, like Chief Keef.
Right, but we've never it's never hit our scale. It's never hit this scale. Right. So like now you see it with Drake and Michael B. Jordan. Like that conversation can go somewhere else.
He was there somewhere. And all I know is Drake looks stressed. I just know he looks stressed on that, but that's all I'm saying.
This is like this is my point. This is
well, the clip that they posted.
See, like this is like
the clip that they posted. You could clearly see because at first I thought it was Drake's joint, right? And then I'm watching the second clip that they posted. She was like, it looked like he asked her a question, and she was like, no. Like that's exactly what it looked like, and I was like, Drake trying bag, man.
I don't know. I mean, they've been kicking it for a while, like him and Amari Bailey. I've been kicking it for a minute, and Drake, you know, he follows this. This ain't the first time like he's befriended like young basketball stars. Like, kicks it with Mikey Williams, kicks it with, you know, a couple of other guys around the country. You know what I'm saying? He's into youth sports as a lot.
No, and that's what I'm saying. Like, I don't want to put that on him.
No,
I don't want to like put her in a position.
It's tough though because it's like people are in those positions a lot. Like even they could be absolutely nothing there at all. But this is what people like us do, people on social media.
Which is
do.
Why I'm saying, this is why I'm saying,
they
I don't
see it and they just jump to all the conclusions.
But this is why I'm saying to you, exactly. I don't want to be one of those.
That, no. I'm
that's why I'm just
it.
Like, I don't
want to do it now. Yeah, all I'm saying is,
that's all.
They were there. That's all I'm saying. Yeah, and, you know, it's it must be like.
I'm going to say it.
Clearly.
Go ahead and say it. All I'm saying is.
We know why he was.
I'm not saying it.
He was there for the game, yes, but come
on. I'm not saying it.
She bad.
Shout out!
I'm not gonna play. I'm not gonna put that on.
He is an incredible talent. I've watched him play for several years now. I had the pleasure of commentating a few games at the Peace Jam when he was about to be a sophomore, I think. And I didn't realize he was.
Where is he from?
He's from Chicago. But
he got a lot of ties. He got a lot of ties in Chicago. That like because I went through his page after like all this shit started.
Oh no, he's the truth.
I
saw him about two summers ago, and he was playing it with guys like. That are in college now. Like he was playing like
he's a
couple
beast.
Grades older.
Nah,
like, he's league bound.
Kids are beasts.
He's league bound.
So. Oh yeah.
Kids are beasts.
We'll be hearing a lot of Amari Bailey.
He might do like one year in college.
Hmm?
He might do like 1 year.
I mean, shoot. Like,
who's the last person that did that?
People are going straight to G League now. Yeah, G League Ignite. You know what I mean? Shout out to John Kuminga, St. Patrick alumni. Let's end the show like that. Last week.
Commencement speech.
Oh, yeah.
Patrick School, shout out to, you know, Coach Chavannis and Mr. Mango and everybody, the whole faculty over there, all the students over there. It was the honor of my life. Mm-hmm. I know I talk a lot of crap for a living. I talk to a lot of people all the time, probably every week. I've never been more nervous than sitting there and speaking to like 100 teenagers.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? I was shook, literally like shaking. And I couldn't even, like I had a whole thing written.
Why were you so nervous?
I don't know. It's like, it's something about like, I could talk to a bunch of strangers.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Like,
but they were strangers.
No,
I was with my teachers too. Like,
So it was like the combination of like new people versus people that know me.
Yes.
Yeah.
And it was you were in the middle.
Okay. And it's like, you know, you walk in there and you know it's a basketball haven. Right. You know what I'm saying? And
as an athlete,
as an athlete, when you walk in there, you see all the retired jerseys of like everybody that went there. You see Al Harrington,
you get retired. Irving, you get your like number Holloway. Retired.
What's up? No, I was not. That's the thing. I think that was the whole reason why they wanted to be there. It's like, look, this guy wasn't shit in high school. Look how good he's going. You know, and I was all right, but you know, all the guys that had their numbers retired up there were either in the NBA,
Kyrie, right?
High D1. Yeah, Kyrie Irving's up there. I mean, he's you know,
a Celtic.
Celtic for life. Oh, that's why I'll always never say a bad thing about Kyrie Irving because he does great things with the Patrick School. He literally kept that school.
His sister was at the softball game.
Oh, she was there?
Yeah.
Right. The designer.
Asia,
Yeah.
Asia Irving was there.
Shout out to him, man, and shout out to the whole Patrick School. Like I said, it was the honor of my life to go back and be able to give the commencement speech for that school.
Nice.
You know, I love that place, and anything I've spoken to him already, I'm going to continue to be involved in that school and talk to a lot of the kids there and you know, anything.
I was going to ask you, is it difficult to talk to, like, because I feel like now that we're older, it's like it's difficult to talk to younger people because it's like now we remember about like when older people would tell us like shit and we wouldn't listen. And now we're the older people being like, listen, man.
Exactly.
Do this, do that.
No, it's not.
Like stay on track.
And that's why
don't get lost in the wrong crowd. Like, you know.
That's why I was nervous because it's like, okay, like I don't even really know how to talk to teenagers really. You know what I mean? I could talk, I'm sure teenagers listen to the show, but like when you're talking directly to them about like, hey man. Like,
you sound like that person that was talking to
it's
us.
It's not, see like, yeah. See, like that's the thing. Like I spoke at Howard, I think like last year.
Mm-hmm.
But they're grown, they're more adult.
They're still lost in the sauce. I mean like to his point, like I get it, but they're, you know, they're still lost in the sauce and coming out of it. But like when I spoke to them, like I told the person that brought me in, I'm like, yo, bro, like, I'm not doing this, like, rinky dinky, like, oh my God, you know, you just gotta do this. And do
yeah.
I'm like, yo, I
didn't do that either.
I went in there, I'm like, yo, bro, it's fucked up out here. I'm like, yo, can I curse?
Yeah.
I'm like, yo, bro, it's fucked up out here.
Yeah.
They don't
wanna be an adult.
They don't love you, they don't like you, they don't need you, and they don't want you.
Wow.
Like, I literally, like, bro, like, I just gave it to him. Like, I don't know.
Who
I,
hurt
I,
you?
No, but it's like, okay, it's,
I wanted to tell them that.
It's like, it's like the things that I've been through and, like, the experiences that I've been through in the industry. And, like, I got started
was
late in my career.
Predominantly minorities?
Yeah.
That's what I'm saying.
So, like, it's like, I had to tell them, like, yo, bro, like, it's going to be hard for you. Like, there's no other way to, like, to explain it.
Yeah. So, it was hard for me to kind of go that route because it is their graduation.
That's yeah, and to that, I was just talking like,
yeah, you don't want to be negative.
Like, celebratory
yeah.
moment, you don't
want to be negative. Hey, man, they don't like y'all, but congrats. Like,
yo. Yeah.
You ain't going to make it nowhere. Fucking with y'all. Congrats. Now, listen, you got to work extra harder, but ain't
gonna
congrats. Make
it. Yeah. A lot of y'all, this is as good as it's going to get.
It's going to get. Hey, you going to frame this picture. Frame this picture, put it up. Blow it up.
A lot of people peaked right here. You don't want to be that guy, you know? And that was the one thing that kind of had me nervous because it's like, yeah, it's their graduation, but like, you know, I can't really give them the advice that I want to mm-hmm. because I didn't go through what they went through. Like mm-hmm. they had to finish through COVID. Mm-hmm. They had to finish through a lot of, you know, incredible, like the whole social uprising. Like there's been a whole lot of things happening
right
here.
Right.
And you know, like, and they still did that. So I kept it celebratory. I kept it real with them.
Yeah.
I tried to connect with them on some, like, you know, they were just, oh man, you work with this person and that person, yeah. you do the show, blah, blah, blah. So like, and the good thing was like, they're such good kids and it's such a tight knit like school mm-hmm. that they all took something from it and they all like talked to me afterwards and nice. Like really interested in that, and I shared my info with
them. That's what I wanted to ask you. I'm like, I know you know, obviously I know you did the speech, but like, how was the connection afterwards? Cause I know like, yeah. I've done stuff like that where people come up to you and be like, oh, yo, you know,
that's what was really cool about it. Like almost, man, like maybe like 40% of the kids came up to me right after or their family or their parents came up to me and was like, yo, thank you so much for that speech. We needed to hear that. Like, you know, a lot of the guys, cause you know, a lot of those kids were me, you know what I'm saying? Like there's always going to be like one or two guys like, okay, he's going to the NBA, but what about the rest of y'all? Yeah. You know what I mean? Like, so all those parents were like, thank you for telling these kids, like, this is, you don't got to put all your eggs in it.
And it's okay,
So
like, it was really gratifying, really humbling.
Nice.
So again, thank you so much, Pastor School. I'll be back very soon. Whatever you guys need me, I'll be there.
Right.
I'm proud to be an alumni there. It was really awesome, man. I almost got choked up doing it, but it was really fun.
No, that's, I mean, like, you know, it's full circle. You deserve it.
God damn it. What, high school, where you at? I want to come back. Shit.
What you doing?
Hello, what's up?
What you doing?
The fuck?
Yeah, what's cool.
What you doing?
I don't know. I want to talk to some kids.
Or what? Like that? With that attitude?
Yeah.
With that attitude? Kids?
First of all, you just, your speech.
It's fucked up out here.
It's fucked up out here. I don't fuck with you.
Bro, like, I'm not going to lie.
Don't talk about my speech. Like, I ain't done yet.
Honestly, kids need a little bit of love.
I'm going to give a graduation speech right now. I'm gonna give my graduation speech.
They need right that. All right, give it to them.
Listen.
You talking to kids? You talking to kids or college students?
I'm talking high school kids.
Okay, high school kids, talk to them.
Ready?
Everybody sits. And now, giving the commencement speech for the class of 2021, Mr.
Loki.
You see him on Apple Music and Beats. Well, it's not Beats anymore, sorry.
Oh, Apple Music.
Hip Hop Throwback. And
Harvard.
Rap Life.
Howard.
He's a Howard University graduate.
He's kind of angry.
He gets a little angry sometimes.
His blood pressure might be up.
Catch him on Taylor Swift has Loki and Rosie sometimes.
Sometimes.
Jose Zabaluza.
Okay.
This is Niall Loki
Ivy. You gotta do the golf clap.
Yeah. Get him, Lou. Get him.
First and foremost, I want to say congratulations to the class of 2021.
Woo! Fuck yeah.
You made it through COVID.
Yeah, fuck yeah.
Made it through Zoom classes. And
Zoom study
groups.
Yeah, Rapuka.
But I want to tell you something real quick. I'm going to make this nice, sweet, and short.
Don't inhale.
The next coming years of your life, male or female, black or white, will not be fun. You might drink a lot.
Like you.
You might get in a relationship and get married. And
yeah, love them.
Have kids.
Yep, get divorced.
Yep. Divorce.
Mm-hmm. Fuck them kids.
Fuck them kids. Fuck them kids.
Some of y'all might have kids right now.
Some of y'all might be pregnant in the crowd right now.
Fuck that baby.
But what I want y'all to understand is you are valuable.
Mm.
You are loved.
Mm-hmm.
Everything that you've went through for the past 4 or 5 years will be used.
Six for some.
will be used to six your advantage. Some. But understand this, there's somebody on your heels right now.
Mm.
There's someone that wants your position right now.
Mm.
So every day, study,
mm-hmm.
articulate yourself,
mm-hmm.
create your craft,
mm-hmm.
create your opportunities,
mm-hmm.
create your life, create your love, because no one's going to do it for you.
That's right.
So I want to say congratulations to the class of 2021. because no one gives a fuck about you.
Oh, that was straight from the heart, bro. That felt honest.
I don't know about you guys, but I'm inspired.
Yeah. I'm about to fill out some job applications.
Ready to join the workforce. All like right. We always do with this time. Thank you for subscribing.
I'm about to join the army.
Food. Low key, Rosie, Jake, Jordana, thank you for pitching.
Your
boy, Eden, we love you.
Yeah. We'll
see you soon, brother. Like we always do at this time, subscribe at youtube.com/Kazeem. You can check us out on every streaming platform, Snapchat Discover. Go to your Snapchat, type in Say Less with Kaz, low key, Rosie, it'll pop right up. Catch us in the streets. Mm-hmm. I'll be back on MSG PM starting next week, every Monday through Friday at 10 p.m.
So nice.
If you're in the New York City area, you can catch your boy talking that talk with my co-host, Monica McNutt, the great Monica McNutt. What you got this week? You rolling?
What we doing? I got a hip hop R&B throwback, like I said, every day, 9 to 10. And on Fridays we were moved to the 12 o'clock slot. This Friday coming up, we are back to our 9 o'clock, 10 o'clock slot. So if you listen to the show, you've noticed a change. We're gonna be back to our regular scheduled program. I'm working on some, outside of this, working on two crazy projects. Shout out to Rory
Lab.
We're getting back in this, we're getting back.
No shout outs.
I didn't want to expose too much. I mean shout out to Kaz, his company is helping us, working on some stuff, so yeah, you'll start seeing
Rory?
Yeah, me and Rory got two projects we're working on right
Ooh.
Now cooking up, so
that's
nice. And happy Father's Day to
Father's Day.
Shout out to my, big Papa Lo.
Yes.
And that's it.
Shout out to my daddy. Rest in peace, Pop.
Yeah.
Love you.
Right. RIP to my pops too.
Rosie, I know you're doing a podcast tomorrow, right?
I am. I'm doing a podcast tomorrow. It's called Black Man Can't Jump.
Uh-oh.
Wait. Yeah.
It sounds like it's gonna be problematic.
Hold on, brother.
Hold on.
It's one of my old improv buddies' podcasts. So
awesome.
That should be funny as fuck.
Awesome, man. Things are moving.
Jake, yeah, what you got?
Yeah, we good.
Chilling.
We checking out the podcast every. Yeah, we checking out the podcast every week. Check out Snapchat, Discord. All the places.
Shout out to Discord, man.
Shout out to Five.
Shout out iSlide. Get some slides.
Yo, yeah. Shout out to the Discord for like them.
They hold us down.
I love fucking them. They funny as hell.
They hold us down, bro. I love the Discord, man. Shout out to those guys.
Jordan, what you got? Chilling?
We chilling.
Yeah.
Dear white people.
You know the vibe.
Hey, Jordan, really quick. Dear white people, say something after.
Talk to me.
Dear white people.
Talk to me.
Let me tell you something.
Dear white people, don't act up on Juneteenth.
What?
Don't act up on our day.
Don't talk to me on Juneteenth.
Don't get her started up. I already see it.
Dear white people, don't talk to us today.
Leave it alone. Give me a little bit of Juneteenth magic to close us out.
Yeah.
Give it to
me. Go ahead. Dear white people, go ahead.
We trying to make shit happen.
Yeah.
So, let's not make this a Cinco de Mayo black version.
Talk to him.
But yeah, and let's actually do something to help the black community.
That's
don't
right,
be problematic.
Don't act like fools.
Affiliate. Exactly.
Okay.
Let's not do that.
Don't
also,
act like fools.
Happy Pride. The parade is next weekend.
Word, shout out. Happy Pride. Shout
and
out to all the gays.
I'm not gay or lesbian, but I'm pulling up to Pride.
But?
I'm pulling up with my whole gay. What do you mean what?
I said but.
Oh.
I think I'm going to bring my lady to a Pride parade one day.
Pride is fucking fun.
It looks fun.
It's fucking
lit.
I'm gonna go with the girls.
If you're comfortable with yourself. And you just,
and you know I am.
You're gonna see some
man,
stuff.
Man, listen,
you know
I'm ordering my outfit this week.
You know I am.
We outside.
I got too many friends in the gay community to not want
they're
to support in any
fun.
Way.
I have too many friends that are gay, and I'm gathering them all up. We're gonna get our makeup done. We're going outside.
That guy either, bro. Support your gay friends.
Support it, man.
Support your trans friends. Support your bisexual.
Yeah, it is what it is.
All, bro.
Love is love, man.
Love is love, man. What people do in their bedrooms got nothing to do with your black ass.
Or your white ass.
Or your white ass.
Or your ass. Yes. Oh, I don't give a fuck what you are, motherfucker. Right, don't got nothing to do with you.
Shout out to everybody.
Celebrate pride.
Happy Father's Day again.
And celebrating Black Music Month as well.
Yeah, Black Music Month is a big one.
Yeah.
Check out the
Black Music Month.
Yeah, doing a lot for Black Music Month.
Exactly.
All right, so let's take it home like we do at this time every time. Stay free. Stay safe.
And always say less.
Say less. We'll see you next week.
Also, my team won. Peace out.
She's lying.
We won, motherfuckers, we won.
With a capital L.
Hello.
What's up?
You went to an HBCU, right?
I say it every show.
Guys. That's right. Howard University graduated.
Listen, man, that school has shaped me to the man that I am today. I'm proud.
You should be.
Yes.
You know what I'm proud of?
What are you proud
it's
of?
It's June,
uh-huh.
And we're going to join Cricket Wireless in celebrating HBCU music programs during Black Music Month,
because
that's
right.
What June is, right? Okay. Because HBCU marching bands are showstoppers from the word go. They are a force of nature and a force for good.
Mm-hmm.
They raise the bar and expectations every single time they set foot onto the field. I've been to sort of HBCU like homecomings and parties, whatever. People don't even get lit for the football game.
Listen,
the Clark
Atlanta, Howard, Hampton, A&T, FAMU, Tuskegee. Bro, like those gotta marching bands are just immaculate, the spirit. And they was in homecoming with Beyonce.
Absolutely.
Wow.
So they are the epitome of poetry in motion. And just like Black music, they are unstoppable.
Mm-hmm.
Shout out Cricket Wireless.
Mm-hmm.